Thursday. Welcome everybody. My name is Adam Patrick Murray. Here at PC World, I'm gonna build a PC. Do you wanna watch me build a PC? I hope so, because you're tuned in here, all 85 of you fine folks. Thanks for joining. Before we go any further, I wanna say I got Willis Lai controlling the verticals and horizontals. What's up, Willis?
Hello, everyone. Good to see you all.
Yeah, good to see you. We will have Elena Yi in the flesh here in the studio. She's running a little late, so she will be here at some point in time. I got a microphone ready for her. She is on her way. She will be joining us, but we wanted to kick it off because it's in the afternoon for us, and I want to make sure to get home at an okay time. So we're here to build a PC, and I know some of you are asking about where's Gordon. He's still on vacation, and while he's gone,
he's enjoying himself.
Yeah, while he's hopefully he's enjoying himself. I was like, you know what? Why not build a small form factor rig? Because that's just what I like to do. It's a short week, you know, having a hard time getting a ton of work done. So I was like, I just build a PC.
Just to relax a bit. Yeah. It was a short week. We just came back yesterday.
Yeah. Oh man, there was a small part of me that was like, ooh, should I just take the rest of this week off and make it like a 9-day weekend? Yeah. I didn't. I'm here. I'm here ready to build a PC. In front of me are some PC parts. Some of them are actually duplicates. Not duplicates, but some of them you get to pick what I'm gonna put inside. But the main draw, the main attraction here is this Fractal Terra. This is new. I got this right before Computex, and I was like, oh man, I cannot wait to build in this. Small form factor, yes. If you didn't know, this is a small form factor rig. Look how small this box is. Like, this is like a toaster. So I'm going to build.
I don't own a toaster. I don't know.
Sure. Yeah. I guess I don't own one either. But this is the latest and greatest, hottest small form factor that hopefully everybody knows about. But if not, you will get introduced to it here. I've seen plenty of videos, and I have opened this up and got my hands on it. So it is a little dirty already for my sweaty hands. But I'm excited to build in it. This is going to be a journey. And the reason why some of this is going to be up to you to figure out is because you can actually configure this system to allow for more cooling on the CPU side, or if you want to shrink the CPU cooling side, you can fit bigger GPUs in it. So I actually have two GPUs that we'll be picking from. So think in your mind for a while. We won't do the poll just yet, but think in your mind for a while. Would you rather see me put an RTX 4080 or an RX 7900 XTX in this system? Because then that's gonna change the configuration a little bit. Or maybe we even try both of them, who knows? I guess we'll see if we have time. And then I do have two different cooling options too, both from ID Cooling. One of them is a shorter tower for the, if we end up going the 4080 route, which is about a 3-slot card. And then one of them is a taller tower if we end up going the 2-slot 7900 XTX route. And then I even got some replacement fans too, depending on which cooling that we use. I want to give a shout out. I don't know if he's in the chat, but a friend of the show, Ziv, he's the one who helped me pick out some of these parts to throw in here. So
yeah, I saw Ziv earlier.
Oh, okay. Hey, Ziv. Awesome. Yeah. So thank you, Ziv, for helping me pick out some parts. I'm excited. Man, when was the last time we did? I guess we did Brad's build, Brad Shoemaker, mm-hmm. and then, but it's been, I
Will,
feel like it's
Will's,
been, a,
right?
Oh yeah, and then Will, but Will built it himself. I'm trying to think of the last one I built. I feel like it's been a bit. I like building PCs, so, you know, it's gonna be a journey. Luckily, if we run into any problems, I have some other backup things. I know that this case says it supports SFXL power supplies, but I'm not actually 100% sure that it will. So I do have a backup on that. I think I have a backup motherboard just in case too, that we have a problem with this one. Anyway, we're gonna have some fun. Before we start building though, I do wanna show you, this is my current small form factor gaming rig. This is a Lian Li Dan A4 H2O. I love this rig. It's 10.5 liters. It's not the cleanest cable management in there, but it is it is nice and compact. This is what I actually have the 4080 in right now, and this is the smallest 4080 that I could get, and it does fit. It just barely fits.
It's very like
really,
snug.
Really scrunched in there, but yeah, I like this setup. If we do end up going the 4080 route, I will pull it from here. If I need a non-SFX-L power supply, I'm gonna pull the one that's in here. And yeah, nothing wrong with this rig that I'm using. It just, I'm excited for the Terra. The Terra is awesome. The Terra is super cool. You know, I'm gonna wait a little bit to open up the Terra because I wanna, definitely want Elena's reaction on this.
Yeah,
but
Elena's gonna want to see that one.
She's definitely gonna want to see it, especially tear it down. And yeah, at the heart of it, I got the Ryzen 7 7800X3D. This rig is mostly just for gaming. Actually, it's not mostly just for gaming. It is literally just for gaming. And so, what better way to get a gaming CPU than use the 7800X3D? It's going to be going in this ASUS ROG Strix X670EI gaming Wi-Fi motherboard. I got some RAM. This is a G-Scale Flare X5. Not the fanciest RAM, but because of the cooler height limitations with this ID cooling tower, this is the shortest sticks I can get without actually just prying off the heat sinks. On some other sticks. So yeah, I think I went over the parts so far. How's everybody doing today?
Everyone's good. Everyone wants me to do a poll right now on whether to do the 7900 XTX or
oh, should we start it now?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Go ahead and do it now. We'll let it fester for a bit.
We'll see. Yeah.
So once again, this is the MSI Ventus 3X. This is the smallest 4080 I can find. Since then, there is actually a smaller 4080. It's the Gigabyte ProArt. Or no, is it Gigabyte? Oh no. Who does the ProArt? ASUS. ASUS does the ProArt, I think. That 4080. I think it might technically be a little bit smaller than this, but this one should fit in the Terra. So I'm pretty sure this will fit. And then this is an ASRock Phantom Gaming Radeon RX 7900 XTX. That's the brand, just in case you want to see it. And this is just a two-slot card. So yeah, I think that's all the parts. ASUS ProArt, thank you, not Gigabyte. So we'll get the poll going. We'll let that fester for a bit. I'm really curious to see what people think I should put in there. I'm half tempted myself to put the 7900 XTX in there because I'm usually not a Radeon gamer, and I'm kind of curious just to see how it is. I should say that this is going to hook up to a TV in my living room that's 4K 60. So even this is kind of like overpowered for what I need, but you know, might as well have more power than less, I guess. So just in case I do upgrade my TV, who knows, 4K 120. You know, I'm going to vote on here. I'm going to add my vote. Oh, okay. So far the votes.
Yeah.
The votes are on the 7900 XTX. All right, cool. A 1080 Ti VC Jester, you know what?
Do we have one?
Where is the 1080 Ti? We definitely have one. That is not actually in the running for me to put that in there, but I think that's funny anyway. Oh, here it is. Is it in the box? Oh, no, it's not in the box. The box is empty. Somebody's running around with a 1080 Ti.
Adam's trying to find that right
now.
Yeah,
I don't know. Or I can, I've got some other, what is this one? I found some really old GPUs. We just have like a big pile of old GPUs over here. This doesn't have, what the hell?
What's it missing?
What the hell is this? Oh, it's an M2 expansion card. This isn't even a GPU. Oh, it just has a thick-ass GPU cooler on it, but it's an M.2. Expansion card. So anyway, that's not a GPU. Why is that in the GPU pile? Anyway, whatever. Let's just start building. Get your votes in now. I'm gonna move all this over to the side. And I've got my Thermal Grizzly CPU guard for Ryzen 7000, and I've got my big thick ass tube of Cryonaut from Thermal Grizzly. And then the drives I'm gonna put in here, the main drive is gonna be a Solidigm P44 Pro, and the game drive I'm actually need to pull from this one, and that's a SK Hynix Platinum P41. So we will pull from that when we need it. Just gonna put that there for now. Move everything over to the side.
VC Jesha says, Gordon probably took the 1080 Ti with him.
You know what? No, he didn't. He hates the 1080 Ti. If he took it with him, he took it to, he opened up the door on the plane on the way over and like just tossed it in the Pacific Ocean. He's like, this thing's junk. I don't want it. We don't want it. All right. Well, first things first, make sure I'm in the shot here. Yep. We got the ROG Strix X670E gaming Wi-Fi, or X670E-i gaming Wi-Fi. This is brand new, straight from the factory. All right, it looks like a small motherboard to me. Look how tiny these are. It's crazy how tiny these motherboards are, and then pack so much power.
So small.
Let's bring that out. Oh, it's so cute. It's
so
just so
small.
Tiny. So small. Yeah. And this does have the double decker M.2. I don't know if you, is this even a riser card? I don't even know what you call this. But who knows. Oh, huh, interesting. It looks like it has that that little expansion thing as well. Okay, cool board. You know, because I'm literally just gaming on this, I don't care too much about the port situation, but you know, it's got Wi-Fi 6E, got the hottest, latest standard. I'm gonna peel the stickers now because I like peeling the stickers. We just got a message from Elena. She's parked and she is on her way
all
up,
right.
So she will be joining us soon.
Shortly. In the chat, Z's Gaming and Home Theater channel. Hello, welcome. Asked, did you get your stuff from Newegg or Amazon? Or your parts?
Honestly, I think it was a mixture of both. I think I know I got the coolers and the fans from Amazon. Mm-hmm. The ID cooling coolers and fans. The power supply is provided by Silverstone. This isn't sponsored by Silverstone. They sponsored our Computex coverage, and this was what they sponsored with. But this build is not sponsored by them, so that was provided. And then both the GPUs were from Newegg. Hmm. And, you know, I might have got the CPU and motherboard from Central Computer, but I don't remember. I've actually had this 7800X 3D sitting around for a bit.
Was it more of a deal focus when you buy it, or was it more like availability?
No, it's just availability. I like to buy stuff that we know, like, it's nice for us what we do here to have at least one of everything like on hand when it comes to like certain CPUs and GPUs and stuff like that. It's kind of hard to have a ton of motherboards and power supplies and stuff like that, but like I like to have parts on hand. So it was more like, oh, hey, you know, what would I do in a small form factor gaming rig in this, the Fractal Terra? Okay, these are the kind of things I would put in there. So that's why like I didn't buy all this stuff recently for this. It was more like, oh, I have the Terra, what do I want to put in it, what do we have on hand. And I think the only stuff that I bought specifically just for this recently was the coolers and the fan replacement. So okay. So yeah, let's awesome. Actually, you know, but before we get in here, I want to see what else is in the box.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Oh, yeah, I forgot. So this motherboard comes with an external DAC. But I'm not going to be using this. Looks like it's over USB-C. It's got a little... Oh, you know what? That's a pretty good action. It's got nice little stepping on the knob.
Oh, yeah.
And it's free spinning. Click in and out. A little plasticky sounding.
Yeah.
But, oh, these are definitely plasticky sounding. But... yeah, whatever. It's fine. Oh, it's got a little mute switch. All right, it's cute. Once again, I'm not going to be using this for my setup. So, I'm just gonna keep this in the box. And then the ROG FPS card 2, I think this is that little extender, but I don't think I'm actually gonna need this. Oh, you know what, I might. Oh, this might have headers on it that I need. Oh yeah. So I don't need the SATA, but I will need, these look like front panel pins, and then USB. Are these USB? Yeah, they are. Huh. Okay, so yeah, if you haven't seen this, I think it's actually on the one I have right now. The motherboard itself has these two little, I mean, they look like USB-C. They could be USB-C, little extensions out of here, and then you kind of, you slot this card in to add the functionality. So it's just adds to the height of it. I think it is nice, especially on a mini ITX board. If you don't need to use the space, and you don't, like, if you don't need any of these things, then it does. Then you can just leave it off and not worry about it. But this is a way to kind of extend it. Do I have it backwards? No, or maybe there is no way to put it backwards. Oh yeah, there is a way to put it backwards, because if you put it this way, this what is that, the USB 3.2 Gen 2 by 2 whatever gets blocked. So there's only one way to put it, and it's this way. So yeah, okay, that's cute. I'm gonna put this off to the side, because I don't know if I quite am gonna need this. Maybe. This feels like a pretty high-end motherboard, though. Like, everything has its own little space. I just noticed on the, what are these, on the fan headers, the PWM headers for the CPU block, it's got these really, you probably can't see them, but there's just these little covers. I've never seen this before. Just these little rubbery covers over the headers. It's actually kind of nice. Like, I kind of like that.
Yeah.
I guess, you know, if you're gonna spend the money, you should get the nice things in life.
New Tech in the chat is asking, did I see a mini fan on the back of the motherboard? Can Adam show it to us? They're like, not a fan, is it?
I'm not seeing a fan. This is the this is part of the heat spreader design. I can't tell what's underneath it, if it's actually touching something. Oh no, it is. It's touching the back of the VRMs. So I think this is just a passive cooling block that's just screwed down. But yeah, I don't see a fan under there.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like, you know what? There is an active fan right here. So this fan right here, it looks, yeah. So it's intake. So it looks like it's blowing cool air, or blowing fresh air, I should say, across the M.2 slots. So that's actually, yeah. I wonder if that's audible. Like, if you can, oh, you know what? And actually the VRMs have a little, looks like the same size little fan right here underneath this the shield. Yeah, okay. So two mini little fans. And let's look what's in the rest of this box. Oh, wow. Oh, good. I've been wanting one of these. A little ROG carabiner. I tell you what, I am so excited. Just kidding. That's a joke. But you know, if you're joining the Republic of Gamers, then I guess you got to show it off. This is the Wi-Fi 6E antenna. This is a USB cable. Oh, I bet this is for the audio DAC. This looks to be I can't tell. This might be front panel. SATA cables. This is a splitter for USB, if you need two USB. Zip ties, extra thermal pad for the M.2s, and an extra quick release for M.2 as well. And then documentation, get ready to rock the gaming world with ROG Strix. Okay. And warranty stuff.
Warranties.
You know, no disc with drivers on it. Oh man, look at all these ROG stickers. Sweet. The game to end all games. You know, I'm gonna I'm gonna take this sticker. Here we go. The game to end all games. Look at that. I'm officially part of the Republican gamers.
Speaking of which, we got Asus in the house. Asus North America. Hello.
Hello, Asus North America. I'm gonna assume it's JJ. If it's not, please let us know. The fan is needed to ensure cool operation under heavy sustained multi-threaded workloads and also provide supplemental air to the separate M.2 heat sinks. Awesome. Cool stuff. Thanks for joining.
Thanks for letting me know.
I'm not going to be doing anything heavy lifting on this. This is going to be a pure gaming rig. Did I go overkill? Yes, I did. Okay, cool. So, I think... Wait, do I need anything else? From, you know what? I'm gonna leave it over here for now. Hopefully that's not in the way. I'm going to put this little expansion card.
That sticker on your forehead, it looks like you just lost a bet to something.
Oh, right. Yeah. Something like that. Let's see what the poll's at. I'm curious. I haven't checked in. 64-36. Wow. Yeah. Okay. We might be going Team Red. All right. And that means if that's the case, then we can use the taller cooler. So I have the two coolers here. We got the IS-55 and the IS-47XT. So if we went 4080, I'd be going with this. If we went with the 7900 XTX, I'd be going with this. So better CPU cooling could be the way. Could be the way. Cool. All right. So let me make sure I'm centered here. First things first, let's put the CPU in, shall we? Now, actually, spoilers, I actually have opened this up before because I think I used this for product photography. So. Yeah, but I have not actually installed it or used it or anything like that. I think I just opened the box to do the product. And oh yeah, there's no fan in here. I forgot. It's just a big box to make it look cool. And you got your Ryzen 7000 sticker because you need more stickers. Oh, that's funny. I don't know if I've noticed this before, but the Ryzen 7000 sticker on the back says not for sale.
Yep.
Like, yeah, don't be reselling these authentic Ryzen 7000 stickers. That's worth something. All right, so you know what? That's fine. Because I think it uses I think both of these coolers use the built-in AM5 mount. So I don't think I need to worry about that. I'm just going to go ahead and put the CPU in. Or wait, I have the thermal guard. Oh, hey, we got a...
Elena's in the house.
We got a... I'm going to close this real quick. Elena is in the house. Hello, Elena.
Hello.
Welcome. Come on over. We'll get you mic'd up. We've barely started. So come wave on the camera. Hello. She's here. thanks for coming. We got some fun surprises for you.
I think I see a bag of surprises.
Oh, yeah, spoilers. Spoilers. there you go if you want to mic that.
Too much.
while she's getting mic'd up, I guess I will put the CPU guard on. I can't remember if the CPU guard is supposed to go on before you put it in or you put it in after. I guess it doesn't really matter. I might as well. No. This is a Thermal Grizzly makes these little silicone guards so that you don't like get spill everywhere. Not that it really matters, but you know, you want your CPU looking nice and pristine. There we go. We'll slot that in there, and then I've got two colors. This is a three pack. I used one of them for the Brad Shoemaker build. Can't remember what color he used, but I've got a black and gray. I'll just go ahead and use gray. Why not? We'll keep the black for later. It's got a little 3M adhesive on the back. Oh no. Can I get it? Oh boy. Wow, this is actually harder to take off than I thought it'd be. There we go. All right, don't mess this up. I guess it doesn't matter if I mess it up. Oh, that's sticky. Oh, this is kind of hard. Oh, it only goes on one way too. I didn't realize that. Oh, this is hard.
Easy does it.
Uh.
Hey, we got Lindsay in the chat. Hello, Lindsay.
Oh, hello, Murray. Lindsay.
Hello. Say hi, nerds. Hello.
Yeah. Welcome.
Welcome, welcome.
You can see me struggling to put this CPU guard on, or this, man, wow, okay. This is hilarious. Oh man, this is way harder than I expected. There we go, because you wanna have it somewhat snug. Okay, this is a horrible idea. Maybe I should just rip this off and not use it. This just doesn't feel right. Let me look at the instructions. Did I put this on wrong? This is so weird. Ugh. Looking at instructions on a, oh yeah, huh. Did I put it on right? It feels wrong.
No.
It feels wrong.
Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, now we can hear you.
Yay.
Hello, hello.
It's gonna be a disembodied voice in the background.
All right, oh, I get it. Okay, oh, okay, I get it. So it's supposed to go all the way down. This is not easy. I also don't think it's worth it, but I'm doing it just for fun.
I thought you did this before, though?
No, not this. This is just like a little aesthetic thing. It doesn't help with performance or anything like that.
Well, that's everything aesthetic relates to performance, obviously.
True, true.
Why else would we put so much RGB on everything?
Oh, yeah, you got your own laptop? All right,
I do.
Cool. Awesome.
I can watch chat.
Yeah,
and
sweet.
Do a couple of other small things in the background.
Okay. All right. Well. Oh boy. Wow. That is jank. Yes, that is jank on my end. Let's go ahead and put that in. Pop it off. Yeah. That doesn't look great. Let's see. I'm just gonna try to push the ends in a little bit. Eh, whatever. All right. So weird. Let's keep that cover. I guess we'll keep this. Well, we'll keep the instructions for later. And let's go ahead and put this back in the CPU box. Keep things nice and tidy.
Hello.
And hello, Elena.
Hello, hello.
She's here.
You made it.
I am.
Welcome. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah.
It's been a long time since I've been in the studio.
Oh, yeah?
I don't know. I think the last time I was in the studio for something was, 2022? Last year?
Yeah, something. I feel like we did
a live
build. Yeah, I don't remember what the build was, but I can move some of this stuff. Get it out of your way.
What's this?
These are the two tower coolers, yeah.
Oh.
We're choosing your own adventure here.
Yeah, you have to tell me about the parts you picked, because I didn't talk to you at all about this beforehand.
Yeah, so 7800X3D, so game is just gaming, so that's what that is.
Controversial pick, though.
Yeah. And then depending on the layout of the Fractal Terra, depends on which cooler I use and which GPU. So right now we have a pull up which GPU I'm going to put in it. If it's 4080, which is 3-slot, then I get to use the smaller cooler.
Mm-hmm,
but if I use 7800 XTX, which is just 2-slot, I get to use the bigger
taller
tower. So
put in your vote too.
Yeah.
For a second, when I was over on the corner there, I saw that and I was like, that doesn't look like the Terra. That looks like the Leon.
Oh yeah, yeah. So yeah, this is my A4H2O. So I brought in because we might have to pull a couple parts from it.
Mm.
But since you're here,
I'm here.
Since you're here, let's go ahead. I'm just gonna put this off to the side real quick. Let's open up the Terra. I'm excited. I'm excited to show you this. And I've seen it before, obviously, but I'm excited for you to see it. Actually, do you want to take it out? Yeah, go for it.
I was looking at this during Computex, and you actually gave me a sneak peek before
sneaky
any of this became
peeky
public.
Yeah, it comes with a card, or at least mine did. A little fractal design card. I don't know if we're on the overhead or not, but
a little
thank you card from four people. I'm assuming these are the owners of Fractal. And it's got a little designed in Sweden kind of.
I like that sketchwork.
Yeah, right. You know, has little notes on it. So anyway, just a nice little touch. That's one of the reasons why I love Fractal. One of the reasons why I love Fractal.
You make some nice cases.
And then I did go over the user guide. There's definitely some good stuff in here. If you want to go back on the wide. I did already open it, I'm sorry, yeah.
I found you out.
I know, yeah. I already messed with it, got my greasy hands on it.
Look at this, it has a cloth protective
Yeah, and this cloth is like surprisingly thick, right? Like this is like...
Feels like a poly version of a flannel.
Right? It's a...
But and it's this actually is... fabric, because look, they sewed the seams.
Yeah, they just sewed in.
It's skinnier than I thought it would be. For some reason, I thought it was going to be a little bit wider.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's actually pretty close to the A4 HGO. I think it is shorter and wider.
Look at this.
Voila. So,
isn't that pretty?
Yeah. So I obviously got the silver version.
Why is it dented already?
Oh, I might have hit it. I got the silver version. It does come in black and a jade.
Dude, that green.
Yeah.
I love it. It's like perfect mid-century modern vibes.
Yeah, I had picked the silver just because I like the look of this, but the aluminium is
turning British
pretty
on
nice.
Us.
Yeah. So you take off the top with this little leather pull tab. I don't know if it's leather.
Or is it pleather?
Actually, yeah, it's probably just leather.
Do you pull it this way?
Yeah,
or
I think
up?
You pull it that way. Yeah, yeah.
I feel like this is eventually going to get pulled out, though. Oh, okay, that's not too bad though, because you have a screw here, so if you needed to replace the fabric or you wanted to change the color yourself, you could do that pretty easily. That's nice. So if you wanted to add your own accent color.
You can actually take that off?
Yeah, look, can you do the overhead
cam?
Right here, it's just a normal screw. So if you wanted to, you just take this off, you know, recreate the dimensions of that bit of fabric and then you could do your own. If you wanted to.
That's actually pretty nice. So you have to pull the top off, kind of like the Q58, the Lanley.
Am I just pulling the sides this way?
No, it's gold wing doors, so.
Is it now?
Yeah, so you just pull from the bottom, look at that.
Fancy.
Yeah, boy.
Does it come off entirely? Sorry, I'm just such a case person.
Look
I'm
at
like,
that.
Can I tear it down?
Yeah, so there's a little thumb thing right there.
Ah. Like
that's, yeah.
I
if you
like
want
it.
To show the overhead, the little latch.
Yeah, so there's a little latch right here.
Mm-hmm. It's like a release latch.
Ah, nice.
Yeah.
Got that Lamborghini door
opening
right there.
I love it. Very classic.
I love the wood accent in the front.
The wood accent's really nice.
Really nice.
And it is actual wood. Oh, yeah, I'm going to take this sticker off because it's bugging me. It is actual wood.
For some reason, I'm getting like moto vibes here.
I had that one. Yeah. It's perforated. There is no. I think the one downside I've heard people say is that there's no sort of filter. Yeah, no mesh over this at all.
You could
so.
Add your own though, if you really wanted to. Like I've been looking at that for the metalfish case I have.
Mm.
So I was on AliExpress, and I think I might buy some just to like. Put over here.
Mm.
The problem with the
is nice it magnetic thing, or sticker?
No, the thing is, I could add magnets to it. So I think that would be nice for this because it's the metal side, right? Because
mm-hmm.
one, you've got the opaque parts here, right? So if you added, if you just like made the mesh wider and you added like the strip of like adhesive magnets around mm-hmm. the edges, you wouldn't see it, right? So you could have it nice and stretched out.
Yeah,
mine's more challenging because mine's a clear acrylic side.
So
you'd see the seams.
Yeah,
so I'm like, that's why I haven't bought it yet, because part of me is like, it's gonna look kind of ugly, because it's just gonna be like very obviously, like you'll just see the outline of the mesh.
Yeah.
Unless I do like the whole panel, which I guess I could do.
Could, yeah.
I don't know.
And then there's this little engraved or whatever into the actual metal.
It's like
the little fractal.
Embossing is this way, so I think it's engraving.
And then on the back of the case, there's a little fractal.
It's very classy.
Here as well. So yeah, very very simple. And then the same thing on the power button, the little F for fractal. And then the wood. And I have seen videos and yeah, like the wood grain is always different and unique. So yeah, it's pretty fun. So you can actually tear it down even further, which we will, but the mechanism.
It's nice weight.
Yeah, it is
like,
actually
nice
pretty damn
solid
sturdy.
Solid feeling like pieces of metal here. It doesn't feel thin.
Yeah, like it's not wobbly.
It's much thicker feeling than that, and that's not too
bad.
That case doesn't actually feel that, you know, wobbly or
I would
light.
Say, except for the panels. Like the panels are, you know, like definitely you can get a little
There's some flex into them.
There's
flex to them, but they don't feel insubstantial.
Yeah,
right?
No, they're not
this,
like
this
wobbly.
This is like solid.
Yeah.
Dense.
Yeah. But then, yeah, so you, once we'll get to it, we'll unscrew these little tabs, and then this is what you actually maneuver the whole spine of the layout one way or the other.
So it's a little bit like the Meshlicious, where you could move it around.
Yeah, so obviously the power supply goes here, motherboard goes here, and then the GPU on this side. They do have other configurations, like you can put a 140 millimeter AIO here, but then you have to use a short graphics card. So they have that option. I wish they would have had a top radiator option, but you know, it's still pretty.
How many liters is this case though? Like 10?
I think it's 10.5.
Yeah, it's compact.
pretty similar to.
That one's 11 if I remember
right. No, this is 10.5. Yeah.
That one's 10.5?
Yeah, yeah.
But then
or 10.4 or something. It's close.
Smaller.
It's close. It's.
Or is it wider?
Oh yeah, yeah. So this is wider. Wider and shorter, where this one's skinnier and taller.
Okay, got it.
So I think what they did, because this one the spine doesn't move, so I think it's like, hey, you know what? This is a room you get to play with, and you can't. I mean, you can put an air cooler in here, but you're talking about like something probably even smaller than this. So this they were like, let's give it a little more flexibility this way.
It's like a minor differences, but it changes the flexibility on what you can do, which I get. It's nice that there's different choices though, right? Like, I definitely think there's gonna be people who are gonna gravitate more towards Leon Lee case, and then there's definitely gonna be people who gravitate more towards the Fractal case.
I mean, I still love this case. And you know what, like this.
Oh, I think this case is extremely easy to build in.
So yeah, like
that's definitely on like one of my, I don't know if it's all-time favorites, but it's definitely a standout.
Like when we're trying to get Gordon to understand that building in small form factor doesn't have to be hard, like this is one of the cases I want to show him. Yes, it's a little more complicated because you know you have to kind of get the cables in and then push in the power supply and things like that, and there's less room to put your hands in. Yes, I totally get that, but in terms of small form factor, this is pretty damn easy.
I really don't think we're ever gonna succeed in winning that
I know,
front. It's just
I know.
Gonna it's just gonna be more fodder for us during podcasts.
It's true. So, yeah, there is support for a fan at the bottom, an intake. It says.
I like that it's outside, actually. Or did you take off the bottom panel?
No, I did. This is the bottom. Like they just leave a lot of room.
Yeah,
for,
so you just like you actually mount the fan on the bottom.
I guess you
exposed.
Could.
Yeah?
I guess I didn't think of that. Well, because if you look, it's got countersunk. So you would mount it this way.
Okay, never mind.
I mean, I think you could.
I thought for a second you meant that you actually were supposed to put the fan like right here.
Let me see. I bet if you had a slim enough fan, do I have a?
Do you have a 15?
I thought I did.
Sorry, everybody.
Oh,
I show
go.
Up and I just derailed the actual build because I'm so into the case.
Yeah. So this is a Silverstone Slim. So yeah, actually you could.
You could. It's,
yeah.
It's not probably designed that way, but I kind of like it.
Yeah, because I think
if you needed the extra space,
you'd
for
be
some
right
reason.
Against the ground, and I don't know if it would like actually take in like
true.
Intake.
That's true.
But, but yeah, so like yeah.
Got to
so,
put it on like a mesh riser.
But yeah, there you go. So I got the
like
little accessory box, but yeah, I mean this if it should fit here. Oh yeah, there you go. So.
Does that fit a 25, like a standard 25 millimeter height fan?
Maybe. So the thing I don't know about is the GPU, or I'm sorry, the power supply. It says it has SFXL support, which that is. So I want to try that at first. But
okay.
I did watch Wendell's video, and he was like, "Yeah, it says it, but you can't actually fit one in there." So I'm curious if you can actually fit it in there. If yeah, so. So yeah, I am curious. Let's put this back off to the side. Finish the little tour with the accessory box because you know we like seeing the
I always
what's in
do
the box.
That.
Here, do you wanna?
Oh, it's me.
Yeah, they got a little stuff on the back. Oh, okay.
Oh.
So that's the SSD tray. If you want to put a 2.5 inch
let's
SSD.
See, we got three cable ties, and four zip ties. A little, I guess if you want to keep your metal panels from looking greasy.
Yeah, a little
and then,
microfiber cloth.
Oh, I like this, separately packaged screws. I prefer it when they're in reusable bags or, you know, ones like little Ziploc bags, mm-hmm, but mm-hmm. this will work too.
Yeah, this one's in a Ziploc bag, but those aren't.
Yeah, I guess I figure you're going to use everything then. I wonder if they don't give you any spares. We'll find out, huh?
Yeah, well, because it's the motherboard, power supply, and then I guess whatever it would be for this.
Well, you have some spares. You should, because it's the ITX board.
So, anyway, that's what's in the box. Cool. What do you think? What's your first reaction?
It's cute.
On the Terra.
I mean, maybe that's not how it wants to be classified. Maybe it's like, I'm the best little case there is. It'll call me cute. But I think it's cute. It's so cute. I like the heft of it. Like how sturdy it feels. If you're traveling with it, I feel like this would probably emotionally feel like it would like. Wouldn't give me as much concern carrying it onto a plane, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, no.
I still think something like that would be fine, but there's just something to be said about the mental perception, right? Yeah. I think you gotta do the side first, right?
Oh, you're right. Yeah.
There you go. You don't leave it off while you're building?
Well, no, I'm just wondering, because the only thing I was thinking of is that there's no way to lock the door. I mean, it's
I think there's like a little lip, right?
Yeah,
so
I mean,
it's like kind of catching on that.
Yeah. So it's not gonna fall open or anything. You definitely have to kind of push it, but yeah, just held with that.
Yeah, I think they probably size the plastic feet here just enough so that you get a little resistance based on the panel.
All right, I'm just gonna put this back over here just for it's easier to grab. All right, now that we've done some serious work, Elena. Do you want to get to some fun stuff?
Yeah.
So first off, we have a present for you that we got in Taiwan.
Me?
Yeah. Do you have it over there?
Yes, I do. One second here.
Oh, I think I do know what this is.
Ready? I'm gonna throw it at you.
Oh God, here we go.
Nice.
Wow, that's solid. That like really hit my hands. All right, I guess I'm opening this on stream.
Yeah, open it on stream.
Please, unbox it.
They got me something from a capsule machine.
You know, yeah, we had...
The first time you went, you were so obsessed with these.
Oh, I mean, I was obsessed with this time too. I just was better at impulse control.
It's like going to a casino where you're like, I only have this much to gamble, yeah, and this time I have this much to spend in the capsule machine.
Yeah, I was like, I'm only getting cats, pretty much.
Elena, let's have you open it center from the overhead shot, yeah. Overhead cam too. Yeah, moving closer. Yeah, there you go. Oh, too much. All right.
I'll
back a little. All right.
This is the PC hardware content you came for.
Come back just a little bit, like right here.
There you go.
I'm gonna zoom in at the risk of messing with the focus.
That's okay. I am that person that will open her presents neatly, and I am trying to take off the tape completely. So that bought you some time. Is this way?
Yep.
Okay. Boom.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. It's so cute.
Aww.
Oh, let's open this up. Oh, I don't need to. Oh, it's furry. It's actually furry.
Look at that. Oh, it's got such cute white markings. Oh,
look at this. Okay.
And it's just sleeping.
It's a perfect donut.
Wait, yeah, and it's, what do you, like?
It's like a paperweight.
It's kind of fuzzy almost. Oh, it's got little beans.
Oh my God, it really does. Although part of the beans, it's on its tail, which is slightly concerning. I need to take this one to the vet. Oh, that's cute. It even comes with a little manual. What is this?
I think it's the other...
It's the other collections.
The other kitty collection.
We couldn't collect them all.
Yeah. I think I do like this white one, though, that's sleeping like that.
Yeah, it's just so cute.
They're all really cute, though.
And then whatever this little boo-boo.
Doo-doo. I don't know. That's super cute.
So anyway,
it's Japanese.
We saw it and we had to get it for you.
I thought this was gonna be Taiwanese, but this is Japanese.
Yeah, I think most of the capsule toys were Japanese.
Yeah, it's all.
It's like velour or something. Right? It's fuzzy.
Yeah.
How funny. All right. It's my new paperweight.
Well, so that's the present part
of
it.
It's sleeping in the capsule.
It's so cute.
That's cute.
So cute.
If I fits, I sits, yeah. Or I sleeps, I guess.
And then we also got some snacks. So
yes,
Willis has got some snacks. I got some local snacks. Before we do the snacks, though, real quick.
Yep.
I see the guay.
I can't remember what drink you wanted. So I got a couple drinks. I got a mango tea. I got weird water. I don't know what.
I love this. It says like very specifically 0% juice.
Yeah, and then cherry Sprite, which I'd never seen before. So
cherry Sprite.
Right? I was like,
oh,
man.
Oh man, this is hard to choose. Like, and I actually want to try.
What is
all
like
of
your
them.
Favorite drink? I thought you were like iced tea or something. Man.
Okay, Western drinks, or are we talking?
No, yeah, from the store here.
Oh. I can't really have it anymore because of the caffeine, but I really like the Arizona green teas.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I knew not to get you anything caffeinated.
Yeah, unfortunately, I can't. Oh.
And then these are the snacks that Willis got from Taiwan.
Golden Oreos. What is this? Wait, dark and white chocolate Oreos? Oh, my gosh. Okay, we are deprived in the U.S.
Yeah, and then lobster tail. These are essentially Pringles, but it's Lay's brand.
Hmm.
There was a lot of good
flavors. I went fancy. I got the lobster.
Wait, this is a mango green tea. Is it caffeinated?
I don't. Oh, you know.
It probably is, unfortunately. But it sounds tasty.
Maybe it'll say it on the front.
Do we have cups? Because I kind of want to try each one of these flavors.
Oh, yeah, we can do that.
Also, I need to check
out. Those drinks aside, we also got.
Oh, Yakult.
Oh, yeah.
This is good for a healthy biome.
Okay, yeah, it does have caffeine. 32 milligrams per can. So.
If you thought I was amped up yesterday during Half Nerd, like caffeine does affect me. Also puts me to sleep because I think my body's like, huh, that's a weird foreign substance that you just put inside the body. We should get rid of it. So I get sleepy. While also being hyperactive. It's a very weird state to be in.
Yeah.
It's just I don't do it very often anymore. Okay.
So yeah, we got all the snacks.
All the snacks.
Goodies,
I'm finally logging into the chat for the stream, which is my original intent of getting the laptop here.
I tell you, it was so difficult to get Adam out of the capsule place. I'm like, Adam, you
like
spent $500.
Those...
We gotta go.
They have one of those like, they're not arcades, but you know, like those just like they have like these. At least in Japan, if I remember right, they'd have these. They're not stores. They're just like little like cut-ins to the building
where they
just have like rows and rows of these machines.
Yes. We went to Ximending for there was also more capsules, claw machines. Yeah, not like arcade, but yeah, just a line of those toys and capsule machines.
And we had to change a lot of cash.
Yes.
We're like, oh
yes.
Crap, we need more coins.
Yeah, I know, that would be in Japan.
All right, so here you go, Elena. You got the, you know what, I'll leave them right here so you know which is which. Oh, I guess it's not hard to tell which is which. Do a little taste test, and then I got cups for us, Willis, too.
Nice.
And thank you for bringing the snacks. I'm curious, Elena, are you down to try some lobster Pringles? All right,
like, it doesn't weird me out.
Yeah, they survived during the bag check-in.
Oh, this smells really good. The like mango peach. Oh, it's not even peach. It just says peace. That's the name of
green
the thing.
Green tea. Oh yeah.
It's just mango
peace tea.
It smells really good.
Mango green.
You should
tea.
Try some of this if you like peach. It smells super good.
Do you want to pass that to him?
Yeah.
Try it together.
Thank you.
Also, I haven't had a chance to look at the stream yet. So if you're commenting wondering why we're pausing to eat as opposed to just building the dang build.
Oh, that's pretty good.
This is a tradition for us. We talk about food a lot, and this time we actually have food.
And yeah, so the weird water is weird. It's, it's just called weird water. Crisp and life-affirming purified water with minerals added for taste. But this mango tea is actually really good.
Hmm. Very sugary, a little heavy on the artificial flavor, but still.
Yeah, very sugary.
Still good though. I actually kind of enjoy it.
Keep mine back here so we don't mix them up.
Yeah.
So here's some water, which will probably just be flavored by these crappy.
It doesn't even smell like anything.
I mean, I think it's literally just water.
Oh, it is.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to be different because it has like the octopus on the front.
It just says drink weird.
Yeah, oh, sorry.
Hello.
Cheers.
Cheers. I already drank. I committed a cardinal sin
of drinking other water. You know what I like? I like, what is that? That water with the skull on it. You know what I'm talking about. It's like a death Deathwater. Crap. Somebody in the chat, please remind me what that.
Water with the skull on it. What was the name of it?
Like, it's like Death Water, Death Mountain Water.
So I don't speak any Mandarin. Is there like a phrase for like cheers or the equivalent in Mandarin, or do you just drink? I'm not a Mandarin speaker. I'm not familiar with all the Chinese culture.
I'm gonna butcher it up. Diana's gonna kill me. Ganbei.
Ganbei?
Oh, yeah. Sounds really similar to like
in Cantonese would be Gonbui.
Yeah. Sounds very similar to Japanese, like Kanpai.
Yeah, Kanpai, yeah.
here's Cherry Sprite.
Oh, Cherry Sprite.
I actually am looking forward to this one. I actually really like Cherry Coke. So I may be setting myself up for
disappointment. Have you tried the strawberries and cream Dr. Pepper?
It actually does not sound like something I'd like, though.
Oh, okay.
I like strawberry. I don't like strawberries and cream. At least not like the artificial like flavor like rendition of it.
Oh, okay.
Liquid Death, yes.
I love Liquid Death.
Is it just heavily caffeinated or?
No, it's just water. But it's hardcore water. It's got a skull on it. And it's called Liquid Death.
Oh, you love the branding. You don't love the water. I thought it was.
Oh, no, I love the taste of the water.
I do love the taste of the water. Yeah,
you can definitely tell. There is a taste to it.
Oh, boy.
There is a taste to it. It's just water, though. This Cherry Sprite is not.
Oh, boy.
It's more cherry than I expected. Like, it's a little more syrupy.
Really smell. Yeah,
like,
really.
I thought it was
going
to be a little bit more of like a hint. Okay. Yep.
I think I slept it for a Cherry Coke.
Yeah.
It's not disappointing, but it's also not enthralling.
Yeah, yeah.
That is a lot of thermal paste, my friend.
Oh, right, yeah.
that is a ginormous
big tube.
Thermal paste.
Well, Gordon was like, oh, why do you always get the fancy stuff? It doesn't even come in a big tube. And I was like, dude, the fancy stuff comes in a big tube. Check this out.
Do not question the size of my thermal paste tube.
So, Lainey, when you want to break into the snacks, go ahead.
I will.
I'm gonna keep building, keeping all this liquid
by the hardware, so I'm gonna move this.
Yeah. I'm gonna keep building because people are here for the build, so we can snack and build at the same time.
I can snack, you can build.
Yeah,
how's that?
Yeah, we can trade off and on. So I have the CPU in. I have that weird guard in there. I mean, so look, Elena. It's just essentially like a little silicone thing that like helps spill over. Of the thermal paste.
Oh, so it just basically catches that.
Yeah,
so like
yeah.
That way
so
like you don't have
it.
To really clean off the CPU yeah. if for some reason you take it out.
But it was hard as hell to put in, and look, it's not even like perfect. It's
no, like it looked right there. It's like I don't know if you can zoom in on this or like bring this up closer to the camera, but like right here, this corner, you can see the wrinkles because it is not sitting properly.
Almost got it. Right there.
Yeah.
So where is it?
That is a horrible job up in the corner here. Oh. It's all wrinkly and yeah.
We see it. Yeah.
All right. don't judge me. Whatever. That thing's not the easiest thing to
put on. It's the internet. They're gonna be judging you by default. They don't even know how to turn it off.
True. All right. Got the CPU in. I want to look at the votes.
Well, has the poll closed yet?
The poll has not closed, but I think at this point I kind of need to figure out. Oh, you know what? I can put RAM in. Let's wait another minute. If you haven't voted yet, please vote in the poll. Looks like we have 249 votes. Should we use the RTX 4080? Jeez, not 480.
480.
RTX 4080 or the RX 7900 XTX? Put it in the comment, or put it in the poll.
The poll in the chat.
In the chat, because we need to figure out what we're gonna put in here, and then also at the same time, I need to figure out what cooler I'm gonna use, but, so get your votes in. We'll be closing the poll pretty soon. Okay. Get that RAM. This is real low profile RAM. This is like the lowest. I thought Dominators were some of the lowest, but this.
What type is it?
This is a G-Skill Flare X5.
Oh.
Our friend of the show, Ziv, says this is gonna be able to clear the taller cooler if I need it to. Let's go ahead and put that back there. All right, you know what? Okay, you know what? You have a little bit more time for the poll because I need to put the drives in. So first off, I've got the 512 drive. This is gonna be just the main OS drive of the P44, but then I need to pull my game drive out of this system. So let me go ahead and take this apart. I have a 2 terabyte P41 Platinum, the maker, SK Hynix, the maker of Fastest in Class SSDs.
You still remember the ad read.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Just keeping your hand in.
That's burned into my brain at this point. They're not even sponsoring this.
Amazing.
I'm just giving them free advertising. Can you believe it? All right, so, oh boy. Hopefully, oh, you know what? Crap. Is this the drive? No, I think this is the boot drive because this is just 1 terabyte. So I think there's an order. I need to look in the manual. So I think there is one slot you want to use for the boot drive and then one you want to use for here we go. All right, M.2 installation. Let's see. Different links, nope, they're all 2280. Little pad, yada yada, 2280, 2260. Which is which? JJ, if you're in the chat, let me know if there is a difference. Cause I think, I can't remember if both of them are Gen 5, or maybe one's Gen 5 and one's Gen 4. I like to put the boot drive on the Gen 5, even though this is not a Gen 5 drive and it doesn't matter, but I want to do that anyway. Oh, here we go, okay. So the one, it looks like Gen 5 is the top one. Oh, this is kind of hard to tell. Huh. Oh boy, okay. M.2 slot, page 10. I think that's where I was at. Expansion slots. Oh, here we go. M.2 slot. Gen 5, by 4, M key, 20. Oh, okay.
It says either one works. One is specific to Gen 5.
Oh, okay. So, which one is the Gen 5 one? Oh, the one, looks like the Gen 5 is the one on the actual board. And the other one goes to the chipset. Okay, and I think that's the way it is for this one as well, so. Because I thought I had my game drive was 2 terabyte. This is only 1 terabyte.
Are you extracting parts?
Yeah, because I want to take my game drive out of this one. I guess I don't have to. You know what? Yeah, I can just re-download games, whatever. That's going to take too much time.
What you can do is actually just, if you have an external drive, transfer the game files from this PC to the drive.
True.
And then again to that, because that's still probably going to be faster than downloading all the games again.
Yeah. Well, I got 10 gig. I got that 10
gig. I just walked right into that one. At least it wasn't with Gordon, because Adam won't keep rubbing salt into the wound. All right. So mad. I live in the San Francisco Bay Area, and I have the worst internet, relatively speaking.
Yeah, you gotta get that 10 gig. Dropping screws left and right. What's the use case for this build? It is a pure gaming build.
Pure gaming.
Makes sense, the one closer to the board, new tech, you're right.
Makes sense. Sorry, I just read, I don't know if I can say that because that's a spoiler for that movie. Anyway, Liquid R, I saw your comment, it was very funny.
So
I know the movie's
the
been out for forever, but I still don't want to spoil it in case someone hasn't watched it yet.
Oh.
Excuse me. You saw two?
Yeah, I just laughed.
Yeah,
I was like, wait, what is it? Oh, wait, no, I've seen this movie in film class dozens of times.
Yeah. What? I mean, it's a very famous movie. It's been like more than 50, 60, 70, 80 years? It's been a long time.
Long time.
Isn't it crazy that the film industry has been around more than 100 years now? It doesn't, makes me feel old counting it that way.
Yeah. So it's not a spoiler, but I mean, the movie references Citizen Kane. Citizen Kane came out in 1941.
Yeah.
1941, jeez.
Yeah, we're getting close to, like, what is it, 80 years?
80 years.
It's really
is it a Rosebud reference? Is it?
It may be. Yeah.
Oh, okay, so this is interesting. So, oh wait, does this support 3?
Is the one on the back too?
No, because like, look, this isn't. Like, I thought this other one was like straight on the board itself, but I guess.
Because one of my boards has one on the front and then one on the back.
Yeah, this one doesn't have one on the
back. Which makes me regret having installed everything before I decided I wanted a second drive.
Oh, I know, right? Yeah, I'm just curious. Oh no, okay, so. Oh, so this is just a big old heat sink here.
Here we go, my probiotics for today.
Hey, probiotic, there we go.
Cheers.
There you go.
Yeah, no, it's only two drives. That's interesting. So they're both on a riser, or I guess you would call it a riser. So, okay, so I'm gonna put the half a terabyte on this first slot. And I gotta tell you, this is a beefy ass heatsink. So half a terabyte. This will be my OS drive.
How many gigs?
This is just half a terabyte, and then the other one's 2 terabytes. So yeah. I like to have separate drives for all my stuff.
I don't know if I'm becoming a snob, mm-hmm. or if I'm just this lazy. Probably the latter. I'm this lazy and terrible with my data management. Mm-hmm. But I'm starting to find that 512 just doesn't feel like enough.
Yeah, I mean, this is literally just going to be the OS, so.
Yeah.
Asus reminded us, do not forget to install the optimized drive for the Solidigm drive released last month.
Oh, yeah, the drivers. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Definitely.
Asus looking out for us.
Thank you, JJ, I appreciate it. All right, so there's the 512 in there. Got to make sure to take off the little plastic on the thermal pad.
And we got a $10 super chat from LaSalle the Rhymes the Third.
Hey.
Thank you so much. Thank
LaSalle
you, thank
Rhymes
you.
The Third, thank you so much.
Thank
I feel
you.
Like I haven't seen you in a bit.
I know.
It's good to see familiar faces.
Yeah. thanks for joining
thank
us.
Thank you. Says love the build and have fun. You guys are have fun. You got and hope Gordon is having fun wherever he is. And glad you guys are using this case as well.
Yeah, no, thank you. I appreciate
want
it.
To see the green one in person.
All right, so put that in. Let's go.
Going in.
Do it. You're opening up the lobster tail.
Lobster tail.
I love how the picture actually has like a picture of somebody holding a lobster tail with chopsticks.
Yeah.
I really want these chopsticks. They're really pretty.
I had like 4 different kinds of Pringles over there. The lobster was definitely really good.
What were the flavors you got?
One was the chicken. One was the pizza, I think it was. Mm. And then the other one, which was actually my favorite, was the steak.
Ooh. Oh, the steak one.
They come in separate packages.
Yeah, there's 2 separate.
What? You're not allowed just to go straight through the whole can like actual Pringles? That's me. If you put a can of Pringles in front of me, my friends and I have there's definitely 2 very distinctive camps between us. There's the camp that's like, why would you ever eat reconstituted potato? And then there's the camp where it's like, give me that canister if you're not gonna eat it.
Yeah.
No, this is my whole can. This whole canister is mine. You get your own.
I love these quick release tabs, whatever they're called, for the M.2 drives. Makes it nice and easy. Nice.
You don't like chasing
easy.
Around little tiny screws?
I just lost a screw in there.
Did
I'll
you
have to
really?
Get to later. Yeah.
I've gotten to the age where I start sending myself emails because I can snooze them, where it's like, you need to go find that Z key off the laptop that you just pulled out, because I don't have time to go look for it, but I also know I'm not going to remember to go back to look for it. So I start leaving myself, oh my god, these are baby Pringles, they're so tiny!
Yeah, right? They're cute.
Everything is so cute in Asia. Look at these little itty bitty chips. Like,
switch cam?
I want to hold up my Yakult or whatever this is.
Yeah, here,
hold it up.
For scale, look at this. It's so little.
So tiny.
How's it?
It's kind of got a vague shrimp chip vibe, but it's much more seafoody. I don't know how to describe it otherwise.
It's umami is what.
It's good.
All right. Well, that was. Yeah. Okay. That was pretty easy install.
Thank you.
I just noticed I think I need to add to the back of these I think there's extra. Are there extra little standoff things?
Okay,
yeah.
I'm hungry.
Elena's hungry.
I'm like, I want the chips back. Well, I'm going to share with like two of them.
Huh. Okay. I guess, well, because look, the little pad on the back isn't actually touching the back of the SSD, and then it's making it bow a little bit, so. I think I put it in right. We'll just keep going. All right, so we got the drives. Oh, RAM is in, CPU is in. I think the next is to go for the. Go for the cooler, which means we need to settle the pole. Willis, if you want to go to the wide.
The pole actually is pretty distinctive in terms of the
votes. All right, we got 286 votes. 286 votes. Let's see the poll. Man, 65-35. Look at that.
Really
said the split is very distinctive.
Yeah. That's not half and half. That is distinctive. I said up front that I was personally curious to go Radeon because I've never gamed heavily on a Radeon GPU.
Really?
Dedicated GPU. Obviously, the handhelds, Steam Deck, and
G1
Extreme is Radeon based.
I thought at this point you would have built with one already.
Not really. I mean, definitely not for work. Just because I prefer CUDA. Oh, thank you. I prefer CUDA. You know, for workflow purposes and stuff like that.
That's true. But this is a gaming build, so you don't have to worry about that.
I mean, honestly, we've usually had. That's good.
It is good, right?
We typically have more NVIDIA than Radeon cards anyway. So, I just never really had the opportunity, I guess. But all right, now I'm doing it. Go ahead and close the poll.
Close the poll. All right, closing at 291.
291. Thank you for everyone who voted. We're gonna go with the 7800 XTX, which means I get to go with the bigger cooler. Real quick, there's a small rubber pad. Yeah, I didn't see it in the box. He's saying there's an extra small rubber pad to hold the back of it.
Somebody in the chat just commented like, Pringles and Yakult. I don't think that would be a combination. I'm like, you know what? I'm neither, but I'm okay with trying this.
Yeah. When in Rome. I'm making a mess here already. Let me put this back in.
So sweet, though. Whew. I'm gonna need some of that water, that octopus water.
All right, so it's not in there. It's not in the Wi-Fi antenna, obviously. Not in the SATA cable. Oh, maybe it's in there. Not in the USB cable. Oh, here it is. Okay, I found it.
Found it?
Oh, okay. Thank you. There it is. Thank you, JJ.
Devinish comments. 291 votes, 214 watching now.
Well, you know, we got a lot of people cycling through, so.
They just came here and vote left.
Yeah, they just came here, saw the vote, and were like, I'm out.
All right, sure.
I'm out.
That'd be super funny if other people were also using their alt accounts. Sorry, alt accounts.
To boost the vote.
Oh, man.
Somebody posted on AAMD.
Yeah, they're like, go over and spam the 7900 XTX now. Do it. I want to make sure I don't lose any screws. All right, so I'm going to put one of these extra little pads on the back. I'm glad I noticed. So there's two extra pads in here. Oh no, and I just trimmed my nails too. Oh, crap.
Liquid R says, I voted for my cat too.
Oh. Nice. Yes, kitties can or should vote too. Yes.
Kitties get a vote.
Kitties get a vote.
Especially here. Especially here with this crew. All the kitties get votes. Actually, I would say a kitty vote counts for two. All right.
Wait, do they get more because they have 9 lives?
They get more because they're awesome. They're one kitty is worth 2 humans in my mind. So.
Oh really?
Yeah. That's the exchange rate.
I live in a very full house then.
Ugh. All right, let me put a little pad on the back side of this one. Okay. Okay, there we go. Boom, I'm padded up. Let's put it back on for the second time. I'm getting good at this. Getting real good. Thanks again for joining, Elena.
Yeah, it's nice
glad
to
have
be
you.
With everybody instead of lurking in the chat.
Well, we got to have fun on a half nerd. Willis didn't realize the half nerd was off topic stuff.
Oh, really?
He said he would have joined us.
Oh, bummer.
To talk about making fun of Gordon all the time.
He's like,
to hop in on the Gordon rant. well, remind me again. So, what was the candy tier list you guys made? What's the top 3 for you? For was it like
are we talking about
favorites?
The Western ones? Are we talking about the ones that I also shoehorned into the conversation because I got so excited about Chinese?
Yeah,
my Chinatown experiences as a kid.
So I'll say the website I used, which has like a pre-built list of candies, and then you just put them in. Was almost all Western, and it wasn't even like all of the Western ones.
Yeah, not even remotely.
So yeah, so I did that one, but Elena did kind of her own version.
Yeah, I kind of like bounced between the two.
Yeah, well, so what was the Chinese Eastern side of the candy tier list you had?
So I added in. I mean, technically it's German, but I think you'll understand when I say this because in Chinatown it was so ubiquitous everywhere. Haribo?
Yes, Haribo
like,
again. Yeah,
I used
Haribo
to actually,
gummies.
As a kid, until like my 20s, I actually thought that it was a Chinese company or an Asian company because it was so regular.
Yeah,
like regularly found in Chinatown. I never saw it in American stores when I was a kid. Mm-hmm. I only ever saw it in Chinatown, so I thought it was Asian. No, it's German.
So you said you like the cola ones, right?
Cola ones are great.
Yeah.
Did you get these for me?
I did. Yeah. So we're at the store. I saw that. I got that. I also got this one for you too. Cause.
Oh wow! They're actually made in Germany.
Yeah. When I was a kid, I went to one of the factories.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
I was saying
fun.
That. So for me, my top tier is not the gummy bears. It's the roulettes. So that one, and then this is a close second within the Haribo family.
Nice.
Which is already S tier. And then, do you remember those black currant? Yes, you do!
I should have brought it. I'm so sorry. I bought like a lot from 7-Eleven this time.
Did you? So did they?
Oh
come,
my goodness!
Did they come in like the rolls?
Yes.
Okay,
yes. Blackcurrant rolls.
Yeah, I was looking for a link to share with people in the chat because I knew not everyone would know what I was talking about. And like the only image I could find was like it was actually in bag form. I had never seen so many at one time.
Oh really?
Because like when we were growing up, they come in these rolls. Oh. What's that candy? Rolo? Is that the
Rolo.
One?
Rolo.
The caramel ones? Like, it's that kind of style of wrapping, right? So it's just like a little roll, like with a foil, I think.
Yep.
And you just like tear it off, right? So those also S tier for me.
Yes.
I'm blanking. I was talking about this so much yesterday. And there's just others that I would say like are solidly between A and S tier. So like Hall Flakes, I like. The Marukawa gums, like the ones that come in the little packs with the little square boxes.
Mm-hmm.
Although somebody on the Discord server was like, you know those cause cancer? And I'm like, what? I want to hear that.
I mean, what doesn't cause cancer? Worth it.
I don't know about it's worth it, but that was definitely like, oh, that's so sad. Like my childhood just like, down the drain right there. Part of it, at least. Gosh, what else? And then there's like other stuff that I don't know if you would consider it candy, but that I still think of as more desserty. So like vamoy, what's the English word for it? Dehydrated plums?
Oh, yes.
I don't know how to say it in Cantonese.
Yeah, vamoy.
Oh, okay.
I
didn't know if you actually understood what I was saying because one, my accent's atrocious already, and two, my family actually speaks Toisanese, not Cantonese. It's a dialect of Cantonese, but it's not like exactly the same. So.
But still, it's like, I got you, Alina.
It was like, I think it was one of those things where I said it, and I think you kind of had an idea, and then I said it in English, you're like, yes, okay.
Yes,
that makes more sense now. Which is usually how it goes because my accent is atrocious and I'm speaking Toisanese. Yeah. They're basically dehydrated plums, and then there's the sweet version, which is sweet and also still has like a little bit of salt to it. It's very, what's the word for it? You get very much that whole sweet, salty kind of thing going on, which I like. And then afterwards, it's a bit sour.
A sour taste.
And so when you keep like basically just like kind of suck on it like a hard candy, and then when it's been in your mouth long enough and it's gotten enough saturated enough with your saliva, you can actually like get the flesh off the pit, right?
Yeah.
I don't know how to describe it, okay? It's not, I know it doesn't sound appetizing, but.
You lost me at sour, so.
Yeah, that's true. You don't do sour.
Yeah.
Adam doesn't do sour, doesn't do stinky.
Candy ginger, candied coconut. Yeah. So like the New Year's trays that they set out, I always like, as a kid, my mom would have to like kind of smack my hand because I just like keep going back for the coconut and she's like, you have to leave some for other people. I'm like, what? I do?
Like, it's not who said that? Where's that rule?
I can just imagine you when you're a kid, you're like, you know, kind of like kitties, just like trying to sneak like a paws, just reaching up the table and then just, snatching. It's like, hey.
A little bit, probably.
Nice.
Gosh, yeah, it's hard to, I'm one of those people, unfortunately, where if you like ask me a question like that, it makes my brain freeze up because it almost feels like I'm being put on the spot. Like, not in a bad way, it's just that my brain doesn't think so well spontaneously on the fly. So it takes a little bit sometimes for it to think of all the different things I'd like to eat from Chinatown stores. I mean, Pocky, I guess, but Pocky I don't think of as candy. I think of it as like a sweet snack.
Yeah.
I was talking yesterday, Willis, though, about how much I enjoy going to Japan to try like the different special flavors of Pocky and like the broader arrangement of them. Because one time when I went, I'll probably never see it again because they're so seasonal about these things. They had a dark chocolate Pocky with dried orange peel.
Ooh.
Yeah, it was so good. I loved it so much. I was so sad when I finished the box that I kept the box in remembrance.
Nice.
I'll never see it again.
Interesting you said Pocky because I almost thought Kit Kat.
Oh, I love Kit Kat. But like, that's to me still more of a Western. It's weird because it's more of a Western candy, but then some of my favorite flavors are Asian, right? So like
it's
the green tea matcha ones, like those you get in Japan. So like, is it Western? Yeah. Is it Asian? Is it just worldwide? I think at this point it's just like a ubiquitous worldwide candy.
But I found it so interesting that Kit Kat in Japan just took off like really well because there are just so many flavors that I've never even see or hear in the U.S. here.
I think,
you know, there's like, what was the one I brought last time? It was like, there's like yogurt, there's melon, other types of dark chocolate and whatnot.
I think when I was it Kyoto? We were like really nearby the Kit Kat store or like, it was like a storefront and we wanted to go, but I think it was just like timing is off. So the store was closed and we were like outside like this. We're like, like, what are those weird American tourists doing?
We got 2 pounds from Isle of Tech. Thank you so much. Building and snacking. Call this PC Terabyte.
Yeah. Yes. I dig it.
I love it. Oh, somebody, River 2, mentioned lychee gummies. Yes, that was like a staple for me as a kid. And you always had to be worried about choking on one because you would try to like you.
Wait, they're not gummies. They're Jell-O, right?
Oh yeah.
They're
that's right. They're talking about gummies. I'm thinking of the Jell-Os.
Yeah.
Where like you'd get these, they'd be in these individual serving cups, but they're like molded, like they're perfectly shaped to it. So you would try to like pop it out and that didn't work. So usually most kids end up like just trying to like suck it out. And then you ran the risk of choking on it because you like, it would come out with so much force. It would go straight to the back of your mouth and you'd be like, ah.
Oh, yeah.
My mom actually won't let my brother eat them for the longest time because she was worried he was going to choke on them. Because she's like, he's too little. He doesn't understand how it works. I'm like, Mom, it's fine. I think for him it was like a moment of like, I have grown up when he finally was allowed to eat them.
Liquid R says, Kit Kat I hear is popular in Japan because phonetically it sounds similar to saying good luck in Japanese. I think I've heard something that...
Sorry, one more time?
That's interesting.
That Kit Kat in Japanese sounds like luck in Japanese, right? Oh. Hitokato. I'm not sure.
I don't know. I mean, but I don't speak much Japanese, and the only way I know how to say good luck is like, ganbatte, so there's probably other ways of saying it that I just don't know.
So, update real quick.
How's it looking?
On the build. Looking so far so good, except for those wondering, so I am using the IS55. I did double check. Where's the heatsink? Oh, it's right under me.
I saw you with that. That thing's huge.
Yeah.
Compared to the rest of it, like.
Yeah. So like it does fit. The actual bracket itself like just touches the heatsink here, but it definitely does fit. And then I put it underneath, and yes, this RAM, it just barely clears that RAM. So everything's good there. The one recommendation that friend of the show Ziv said was to upgrade the fan on it. I'm confused though because he had mentioned this, so this Silent Wings 4, maybe I got the wrong one because the one that comes with it is slim, so I'm worried about clearance here. I mean it doesn't add a ton to it, but it adds enough. So I guess we will see. And then this Silent Wings 4 has this weird locking mechanism on the corners. Like you can change how the corners are. I'm not. It's weird. You can change. I don't. I've never seen that before. Have you seen this before? Where you like change out the corners?
Oh, interesting.
So this is like the default corners, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like just a normal. And then I don't know what the hell this is. They're rubber, so maybe this is just like a different kind of way to
rubberize
it.
Yeah, so maybe this is for if you really are concerned about noise, because remember, Be Quiet is all about sound dampening and no noise. Because right, if you have this pressing up against something, it's not going to vibrate nearly so much, I think.
The only thing I'm worried about now is that neither of them accept the screws.
You might need to use those rubber quote-unquote screws, the ones that you pull through to mount.
Yeah, but I don't know if you can do that on here, because look, there's...
I mean, probably not,
Oh, wait, here we go. Oh, yeah, okay. So, yeah, but that doesn't fit either.
Liquid R would like to know, do you drink margaritas? Because they're sour.
I'm so confused. I'm not a huge margarita fan.
It tracks.
Yeah.
Not even sour beer, right?
No, I hate sour
beer. Oh, yeah.
Are you
kidding?
Yeah.
Oh, that's
the worst.
Wait, Ruru, too, there's a guava candy? Please tell me, because I love guava. I would like to try this.
Say more.
Yeah, say more, exactly, right? When I went to Singapore for the first and only time so far, the first thing I did was I went to a 7-Eleven, I opened the door to get a drink, and I was like, there's so much guava. I spent a lot of money on guava drinks that trip at 7-Eleven. Also, 7-Eleven is amazing in Asia. I don't know why we have such terrible 7-Elevens in the US, but so different.
So good. Yeah. And just Family Marts, and they're literally everywhere.
Mm. What was that beer? Was it a beer that we found, Adam, with the cat meme?
Oh, yeah. I can't remember exactly, yeah. You know what? I can always add a fan later. This is like boggling my mind. I don't want to just sit here and and twirl on it. So I'm gonna set this aside. I'm just gonna install it with the stock fan and then address the fan later if I need to. So let's go ahead and put this stock fan back on, because that is, for some reason, just making my head hurt. And I don't want my head to hurt. So let's go ahead and put this back on. I feel like I've maybe got the wrong fan, because I feel like it needs to be slim.
Tim Lau, I do want to know, how did you know what a Jell-O shot was at that age?
Not that kind of shot.
Well, it's funny because in the chat they're saying that talking about the lychee jellies that we were talking about earlier, mm-hmm. they're saying that I squeezed the bottom and then sucked the gel out of the cup. I brought it to school once and mentioned that it was like a Jell-O shot, and a student teacher was said, "How do you know what a Jell-O shot is?"
Almost back.
Escamonster says, this is not a PC build stream, it is a food stream. Rename, please.
Food stream, and then I'm just happened to be building a PC.
It's a full stomach episode, yeah. Really.
It's a PC terabyte show.
I love that. We should actually have a little sign that says, yeah. Like.
All right, so cute. I'm gonna open up my big, thick tube of thermal paste.
Dude, that thing is gigantic.
Thermal.
Can we get an
grizzly?
Overhead shot of this? Because
yes,
look,
yeah, it's on
like,
overhead.
Adam doesn't have small hands, and that thing looks huge in your hand, bro.
Yeah, this is, it's...
Jeez. It's not even just
and
like...
it's heavy, too. That is a lot of thermal paste.
Oh my gosh. Anything I want to say about that is going to get completely taken as not safe for work, so I'm not going to say it. But that is a very hefty tube.
Hefty, hefty, hefty. And if you know me, you know, right. I like to glob on the thermal paste, so.
Remember, Steve's video says there's no such thing as too much thermal paste, except there kind of is, just in terms of mess.
Yeah. But I have the guard on, so, you know.
Keep that clear, but
yeah.
The motherboard. All right, I'm not even gonna ask Willis to do a real poll, but informally, chat, should I start with the golden Oreos or should I start with the dark and white chocolate Oreos?
Informal poll.
Informal going, poll.
Going in.
Oh, you're gonna take a real poll?
I know. I mean, I can.
No, it's okay. I don't think we need to.
What was it?
Oh, interesting. Hmm? Oh, huh. Have you installed with this cooler before, Lena?
Huh?
So you actually screw it in by reaching through the fan.
Oh, that's cool.
To get to the...
I like that.
So, yeah. Huh.
No, I haven't used this brand before.
Yeah, this supposedly is... I haven't used them before. It was Ziv who recommended it, so thank you, Ziv. I think it's...
Oh, Devinish says that the soft corners on the fan are for mounting to a case. So I'm guessing it's because, like I was saying, like it's more likely to have vibration when it's like pressed up against the
Okay. Well, then, okay. So the screws weren't long enough then to reach for this use case for some reason. So I don't know. Luckily, that's an easy swap. So I'll do that later. I think I'm in the hole. Oh, I have a flashlight. I forgot my flashlight.
I'm also, I'm impressed, but also slightly scared that people remember things I say about my food preferences. That is true. I do like around 72%, as high as like 85% cacao, dark chocolate. I should stop sharing things about myself, apparently. Y'all have two good memories. Also, I guess it's forever preserved on the internet. So.
Too late.
Womp womp.
Okay, this is... Sorry, I'm reaching over the overhead. I have to... I guess I can just twist the motherboard, but...
What? There's a dark chocolate Almond Joy now? Oh, I'm gonna go investigate this. I love Almond Joys, actually. Well, I don't know if it's S tier. It's like A tier for me, maybe. People are saying golden.
Go for the golden Oreo.
Golden Oreo. All right, let's try this.
Oh, there we go. I heard it. Okay. Oh yeah. Okay. Yeah, that grabbed. This is not the easiest to install.
Matt Thayer, that sounds very decadent. Peanut butter Oreos dipped in milk.
There we go. Okay.
That sounds very decadent.
Yeah, I've done that when I was a kid. Like,
these
just dipping
tiny
in Oreos.
Oreos. Look how little they are.
The size are.
And the
are
diameter?
They? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they're little. Everything is sized so cutely. Maybe that's why they're not fat.
Wow. Smaller portions?
Smaller portions. Smaller sizes. I can definitely say I gained weight during the last couple of years, so I am definitely, I could probably use Asian size instead of Western size portions right now.
This will be easier to dip in milk, I guess. Or just make it like a, there were Oreo cereals before.
Were there?
Yeah.
I was never much of a cereal person. Like, Oreo, I think cereals. At most as a kid, I wanted to try Lucky Charms because I thought they looked, the marshmallows looked so good in the commercials.
Oh, yeah.
And then after a couple of times of trying it and realizing how terrible freeze-dried marshmallows are, I was like, Mom, this is terrible. How come it's not like how it advertised? And she's like, that's what advertising is. They lie to you. And I'm like, oh.
That's like how your mom puts it. They just lie to you.
I mean, she didn't say exactly like that, but that was the gist of it. Like, basically something like, you can't trust everything you see in advertisements. And so my child brain was like, oh, they lie to you. I get it now.
All right. So... This is a compact little package.
Would you like a golden Oreo?
It's still a little
would
bit of
like
clearance on the RAM.
How many would you like?
So it's not actually touching.
Okay.
And it's nowhere is it touching around the edges of the motherboard, the heat sinks. Nope, this box is not laying flat.
All the hardware you chose have really nice looks and very sleek.
Yeah, you know, and I also went with I think there might be some RGB on here, but I didn't want to go totally bling bling RGB with this.
I just really like this look, like with the perforations. It has that kind of animatrix look of the laptops that Asus does.
Yeah. All right. So, forgot to put this in.
Eskimo Monster is out because we're not doing enough PC building.
Not doing enough PC
building.
Too much
food.
Too much food.
Not enough
Eskimo Monster.
PC building.
Sorry. Sorry,
you want to try a golden Oreo?
I do. Yeah, these are tinier.
They're super little.
Watch this.
Wow. Remember when Gordon did the beer?
Yeah.
Oh, that was scary.
He did the beer on a fan?
Oh, you want that? I know.
I am impressed that you put your food on your PC hardware and then still eat it.
It's new, it's okay.
Yeah. So check us out. These fan headers have little rubber covers.
Ooh.
Fancy.
How much is that board?
A lot of money. The PC part picker list is in...
I'm guessing around 200, 250? There's some accent.
430.
Oh my goodness.
This is a high-end board, Elena. We don't mess around here.
Oh my god, I forgot how expensive AM5 was. Is
well, I don't even think it's just that. I mean, it's.
This is
a high-end board.
I mean, it's a nice board. Don't get me wrong.
This
but
is a high-end
just...
board. It's like X670E. So
my sense of pricing is still stuck apparently in 2018, before the pandemic, before inflation, before AM5.
All right, so I don't need that. Okay. Motherboard done.
Davina said that the Oreo on the fan was like a cat on a Roomba.
I like that. All right, so GPU on this side. So I'm gonna... So I think... Yeah, so I can install the motherboard without having to... Or I mean, I can move the spine even though the motherboard would be installed. But I do want to kind of just get a feel for the sizing. Oh, you know, I guess it doesn't really matter because if I'm going two slot on the GPU, which, yeah, maybe I should just whip it all out now and just kind of like eyeball it. Because I think I want the GPU closer to the edge, which means I might even be able to upgrade the cooler to a non-slim version. So let's...
Sorry, excuse me just for one second.
And Alright, so, and I've never used an ASRock. Actually, I've never used an ASRock motherboard. I don't think I've ever used ASRock anything.
Really?
Think about it. Yeah.
You didn't use that, the ASRock live mixer that they showed at CES? The purple. I think we have one.
Oh, here. Yeah, we have one. Yeah. I've never used it.
Mm.
Oh, interesting. Okay, so this Phantom Gaming, it's got transparent plastic piece, and then you can kind of see underneath, but the words are both on the plastic and the metal. I don't know if you can actually see it or not, but interesting. Oh, the same thing kind of here. All right. You know what? I guess I'm wrong. I thought this was a two-slot card.
Oh my.
So...
are we going to have to scrap plans for a flagship GPU?
No. I thought I had...
I mean, this
is... oh, this one's at home.
I mean, this one is...
so I have the 7900 XT.
It's like a 2.5?
Yeah, I guess I was wrong. I totally thought that the 7900 XTX that I had was a Sapphire version, not an ASRock version. Which the Sapphire version is two slot. So it's probably good that I'm gonna eyeball this right now, because, yeah, let's put the GPU in. Which it's actually, you know what? It looks like it's at 2.5 slots. I guess oh yeah, this isn't gonna fit. It's too long. Dang it, I grabbed the wrong.
I know.
GPU. Oh no. Oh no. Good job, Adam.
Uh-oh.
Good job, Adam. I grabbed the wrong GPU. I meant to get the 7900 XT because it was the two slot Sapphire version.
Oh.
This Phantom Gaming is just not gonna fit.
Dude, that is monstrous. Like,
yeah.
You could like this is one thing that I do like about the Leon Lee A4 because that probably would fit if you had clearance through the front, right? Because I think if you had assuming it would fit width-wise, but length-wise, you could still put it in through the front on the A4.
Dang it. All right, now let me, after that whole poll and everything, we might end up going with the 4080, but now I measured it out. I feel like, dang it, I grabbed the wrong GPU. But I'm pretty sure this 4080 will fit. You know what? Okay. You know what? I think I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna switch and go to the 4080. I am gonna use the 7900 XT. So I have the box here. I just have the GPU at home. So I'm not going XTX. I'm going XT. Oh, I am so sorry, chat. I got the wrong GPU. But in the meantime, I'll just throw a different GPU in here. I think I have that one at home. So I have a. So if that 7900 XT, this 4080 does fit. All right. So now, yeah. Now I want to show people that this 4080 fits, because I definitely did. And I can feel Gordon's smirk as well, Ivan.
Gordon's smirking from
the other side of the world. He's like, haha, stupid small form factor. You can't even fit a GPU in there.
Oh, man.
But no, I'm not going to go Arc or 46. I've got plenty of GPUs to pick from, but... dang it! Oh man, I totally messed up. I am so sorry, chat. All right, but I do want to show that. I'm pretty sure this 4080 fits. So let's.
Are we gonna use that just for illustrative purposes?
Just for illustrative purposes. I'm not actually gonna use it. I am gonna use the 7900 XT.
Ooh.
But I do want to show that this beefy three slot card. Oh, you know. So this actually has three brackets. Like it's not a two bracket card. It is a three bracket card.
is it a full 30?
But now that I'm thinking, so see, there's three brackets.
Are you gonna have to reinstall your cooler so you can fit a three slot? You could just do that.
No. Chat said go Radeon. I'm gonna go Radeon.
That's fair.
I'm not gonna switch to the 4080. This is not me trying to shill for NVIDIA.
It's not that. It's just that if you had a third slot, couldn't you potentially fit that ginormo chunky card right there? That's Radeon.
No, this is too long.
I think you might. I wonder if you could maneuver it. I'm sorry. I just.
Yeah, no, go for it.
I don't disbelieve you. It's just I'm stubborn.
In the meantime, I will get this.
And if nothing else, this will be entertaining for the stream to see how I fail. I always say to everybody, my videos are not to establish my authority, but to tell you how not to be like me. You don't have to make my mistakes. No reason to waste that time. I did it for you. Oh, if it was an A4, you could totally get this in, dude. Like, do you know what I mean?
So this is literally the longest that you can get in this A4H2O. So let's see the length compared, because I actually don't think that'll fit in here.
Adam, how willing are you to try to take off the front panel?
You can take the front panel off, yeah.
Because I think it will fit if you take the front panel off. Don't quote me on this. Here, like, just see, like, eyeball it with me.
Real quick, yeah, just, I wanna see.
Like, eyeball it with me, because if you have this, like, over here.
Oh, yeah, see, look.
Is it just a little too long?
Yeah, it's just a little too long. Like, right here, it lines up, but it's this plastic, yeah.
Yeah, but I think, let's just see, right? Like, if you were to imitate this being where it's at, I think it might just clear.
Oh, maybe you're right.
I think if you took the front panel off, it would fit.
All right, for science, let's try it. But first, I do want to show that this 4080 fits without having to do that. It's just going to be tight.
Ooh, you're going to have to, like, angle it in. Yeah, let me. Take the thumb screws out.
And also, I'm going to take this. You know what? Interesting. We're literally seeing the practical limits of this.
Everybody's saying take the riser cable out first. But why?
Take the riser cable out first. Install it. Oh yeah, because you can install it. You can install it in the bracket and then slot it in.
Oh, you can? That's nice. That's a nice feature.
But I'm just. I don't think you have to.
Okay, yeah, so Shasta's Eddie says, you must take the riser cable out to shoehorn big GPUs in. I put a 2.5 slot in my Terra. Hmm.
All right, let's try it. Let's try it.
I also love everybody in chat saying for science.
For science.
For science.
Yay.
For science.
For science.
But this power cable is definitely getting in the way.
This is the reason why Gordon doesn't like to build small form factor, I think. This is my pet theory, or hypothesis, because Gordon would never admit to it, because to be pinned down means you can't, like, always shift your argument. And that's one of the things that we know and love about him. Yeah. Love about him. But my suspicion is that he just hates having to deal with, like, the extra finicky part of, oh, I gotta take this part out. Oh, I gotta deal with this. When you have a big freaking case, you can just shove it in any order you want. You can have the cables hanging out. And we know with Gordon, he will have those cables hanging out. Oh, yeah.
Cable management is not his strong suit.
Have you seen his test rigs before? Like, the way that
I've put it in videos before, and people are like, what the hell? I'm like, yep, that gives me anxiety. So, all right, so let's go ahead and screw this in. All right, so I've screwed it into the riser card.
Wait, are we doing this just for science first, and then doing more science?
Yeah, the 4080 one is just for science to.
Okay, and then we're gonna do more science.
Because I know this 4080 fits. Or I don't know it, I haven't tried it, but according to the measurements, this 4080 should fit. There we go. A little bit of grinding. Okay, so yeah, there we go. The 4080 is literally literally in there. We got the thumb screws would clear. So it is right at the edge. So
snugged right in there.
It is snug. So yeah, this is essentially the same amount that'll fit in the A4H2O. Like I definitely did look at that. So Elena, the only thing I'm worried about, if we try to take the front off, so if you think, okay, this shroud piece is what's longer.
Oh.
Like, you know what I mean?
It pushes it forward, huh?
Yeah, yes, we have just a little bit of room, but not enough that shroud would clear here.
You think so?
Yeah.
I wonder why that is. I guess maybe it sits more forward than I thought. How close are we to being done with the build?
I mean, I guess I can put the other stuff in first, but it'd be easier to...
I kind of want to see if it works, but I also don't want to prolong this too unnecessarily.
What do we have, 3? When do we start? 1:15?
Yeah, it's almost 2 hours.
Oh, no, it's 3.
We're almost at 2 hours.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, now I can't get it out.
Yeah. Ruru2 says, fits like a cat in a box.
Yeah.
Like my cat, my new cat in the capsule.
All right. Wow, I can't even.
Did I suffocate my cat?
I'm having a hard time getting it out.
Oh. Watch your fingers.
Or maybe I need to take the front panel off anyway.
It might be easier in general just to do it for your building.
Yeah.
But will you be able to take it off from the front, or do you have to unscrew it from the back?
Yeah, so there's 2 screws here.
It looks like there's 2 screws.
And then there's 2 screws here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, so. These are the ones that hold the
wood. Yeah.
Okay, got it.
All right. We're taking the front panel. Oh, you know what? Actually, there's 2 more screws here. Or no, 1 screw there.
Eddie says, I've taken my Terra apart like 5 times just to do all the wire tucking.
I know.
OCD things.
Oh, God. Both of my small form factors, I have definitely taken apart multiple times. And like I'll be watching something with Lindsay on the TV, and
yeah,
she's like,
what
are you doing? And I'm like, yeah, I'm just gonna take this apart again.
Yeah, that's what happens. Especially if you do it while doing something else or talking to somebody, it's really easy to get distracted, and you're like, oh, whoops, I'm gonna have to undo that.
Hey, Willis, do you mind hitting the AC?
Oh,
I think
yeah,
it clicked over.
BRB.
Sorry, I get warm, especially under pressure here. Under pressure.
On the hot seat.
Under pressure.
This is why I talk about snacks. There's no pressure about that.
Why can I not get this screw out?
See, JJ's like, just forget the discrete graphics right now. Just post with IGP. You know what? I like the way you think.
Yeah.
Easy way out.
It posts. Just without a graphics card.
So, funny story.
Yes.
I built in the metal fish case, which the T60 is now discontinued, which is sad because I really like that case. I was going to recommend it to a couple other people. But
why did they discontinue it?
I don't know why they discontinued it, but it's pretty sad that they did. It's a nice little case. But I realized that I bought the version without a riser cable, and I've been lazy, and I have yet to buy a riser cable for it. So. I've just been running it on a 5600G. And I keep telling myself someday soon I'm going to buy that riser cable and actually put a discrete graphics card in there. But it actually worked out because I've been using it as part of like some energy consumption informal testing like between the different computers I have.
Oh, interesting.
So it kind of worked out. And I may or may not admit to this being accidental in my write-up for PC World. You all get to know the behind-the-scenes story.
Behind the scenes, exclusive.
Exclusive content, just for you.
Oops.
I heard that.
Yeah. I dropped a screw. Bound to happen. You just shake and hope that it comes out. It didn't come out. It'll come out at some point. So these are the front panel. All right. So now we are clear. We are clear from the front. Thank you, Willis.
Oh, I can feel that AC.
Yeah.
I have busted out the Oreos that have the dual personality filling. You want one or two? Okay, 1 second.
All right. For science, now let's switch over I have all these screws here, and there's I was keeping track of where they go, but now I forgot.
It's so. All right. It'll sort itself
we'll figure
out.
It out.
We've built enough. You'll be able to tell it apart on site.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, thank you for having faith.
I'm going to do this.
Overhead?
The twist.
Do the overhead.
Oh, it was terrible. I did a terrible twist. This is so bad. That's what I've done.
Oh, that's pretty bad.
I know. I'm not, I'm never
throw
going
it away.
To,
do
I'm never
one.
Going to be chosen for one of their commercials now.
Okay, so now we're going to put this Azeroth card. Okay. So it's a little clip. It's actually kind of cool that you can take the riser card all the way out like this.
Why is it's a that? Nice feature.
Have you guys ever tried taking the Oreos filling out and then just putting it in milk and just stirring it?
As a kid, I did. And I actually did that because I actually don't like the filling that much.
Oh, the
I
like the part.
I know, you like sugar. I like the cookie part more because it's not as sweet.
Yeah.
All right. Thumb screws
oh,
in.
Wow. That's really milky.
Very milky. Indeed.
Almost like cream cheese flavor. I don't think I like that.
I forgot what the description says. It's just vanilla and chocolate, right?
But it has the white part has almost a cream cheese kind of like vibe to it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I like it.
All right.
The golden was definitely better.
All right, so. Put that there.
Oh, we're doing the science.
Hmm. Yeah, so this is science. So this is the Azeroth.
Oh, you're right, I think. I don't know if it's gonna fit.
Why does it feel like it's not clamped in all the way? Okay. Oh, maybe. I don't know. I need to put this all the way back together just to see. Oh, God, dang it.
I'm switching to the wide cam because we have Ian.
Ian
here.
Ian?
Ian in the house. Tech Tips Potato. Hello.
Is that Ian?
No, that's not Ian.
That's not Ian?
That is not Ian.
That's like an alternate channel, right?
That is a faker. they have admitted to being a faker.
Oh, okay.
Because we're looking for Tech Potato.
Tech Potato. Oh, okay. I thought he changed his channel name.
No.
Yeah, it says, could we please have a change of scenery? I want to see Adam's struggling face.
Oh. Like that. Yeah, we should get a face cam. You know those like rigs? Yeah, with the little camera right here. Like,
Hook up a GoPro.
I don't understand why people like that view. I find it slightly disconcerting.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because it's not natural. Like, I'm never going to really look at somebody from that perspective.
I think it's just if you really want to see, you know, up close and personal what's going on in somebody's mind. Because right now I'm like, I feel like I'm ruining everything.
Adam ruins everything.
All right, so... Oh yeah, so let me get, there's one more screw. Where did that other screw go? I don't know where that other screw went, but there's one more screw that goes back here. I think it's this one. Just to make sure it's solidly in there. I don't think that's the right screw. But it is. It is holding. It's doing something. So I'm just going to use that one. Oh, you know what? I think it's the right screw. I got screws everywhere. All right, so I'm going to hold it up.
See. I think it's just a little too long.
Oh,
it's just a little too long.
Actually,
No,
yeah.
I can see it because it's not clearing the frame right here. I was wrong. My eyeballing was wrong.
Oh, that's so close. So it's hard to tell right now, but like, it's like this right here. It's like that.
I mean, can you just take off the shroud? Wow.
Not the shroud.
The shroud is just a little too long. You can. Well, actually, you know what? Oh, you know what I think it is?
Hmm?
I think it's this.
So
this has built-in grooves for the cable.
I didn't anticipate that.
So you know what? If that wasn't there, it would.
So my eyeballing my eyeballing wasn't completely wrong. It just forgot to accommodate for that part.
Well, I don't know, because look, it's hitting the corner here too.
I didn't want to hear that.
No. Oh, it's so close.
Shastis Eddie says, get the Dremel.
All right, I need a snack. So here's some other snacks I got.
Oreos.
Oh, thank you.
Lobster chips.
Do you taste the cream cheesy kind of vibe to it?
I don't taste.
Yeah, that's not just vanilla.
It's like got a kind of cream cheese.
It doesn't
cheese.
Taste just vanilla.
It tastes kind of like cream cheese vibe to
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
So we went to our local supermarket to get some other snacks and the drinks and lunch and whatnot. I also found these. Like I love. Do you love these little wafer
mm-hmm.
things?
Mm.
Yeah. So it's different than like.
My mom liked the hazelnut one.
And then this was like a. It said European biscuit, so I was like, okay.
My mom also likes those too. My mom likes her snacks.
Oh, good.
That's where
good.
I get it from. It's also where how I ended up gaining the extra weight because my parents kept giving me snacks during the pandemic.
It says number one in Italy. So you know it's good. I love these things. When I was a kid, I definitely destroyed the hell out of these. Oh, yeah, they're the same
hazelnut
kind of
ones were really good.
Yeah. But I used to get the sticks.
Oh. Mmm. Garden Company. They used to make those wafers. Do they still?
Garden Company?
I think that's what it's called. So the wafer type snacks like that you get in Chinese grocery stores.
I gotta see the brand. I need to see the image. Yeah, yeah.
Look how fancy.
Next time I go to like Ranch 99, I will take a picture if I see it.
Yeah. Look at that.
Ooh. Look at that.
It's a fancy little
Some
boy.
Some medieval dude.
Well, that's good.
Hmm. How are you feeling, Adam?
All right.
Full of chocolate.
Boria Zero says, just stand on the front panel.
All right. All right, well, that means the card that I thought I was going to be using, once again, was the Sapphire 7900 XT, not the XTX. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that is a pure two-slot card. It might just be over just a little bit. It's definitely short enough to fit in here. I'm not going to go to the 4080. Chat has spoken. I'm not going to go to the 4080. I just wanted to show
no Nvidia
that it would fit. Like,
no Nvidia.
Like that 4080 is like, that's the most powerful GPU I thought I could get in here. But that 7900 XTX.
These are so good when they're fresh.
Right? Those are good.
They're so good when they're fresh.
So, okay. Oh, snack. Oh.
Tim Lau, I think, has it. The Garden Cream Wafers.
Oh, gonna pick that up. Garden.
All right, let's take this. let's take this back out.
Mm. Davina's right. The Chinese Phoenix Roll cookies also very decent.
Oh yes. Okay, now I remember. But are they Chinese or are they just? Sell it at Chinatown a lot. I
always thought they were an Asian company, but I could be wrong. Like I said, I was wrong about Haribo.
Oh, Garden. Oh, wait. That's. I remember that chef logo. That little chef with the hat logo.
Hello, Nick. What's going on? Good to see you, mate. Yes, this is Gordon's favorite form factor.
Absolute favorite.
That's why he was so excited to be here.
He's like, so excited. He's like, he had to get out of the country.
He's like, oh, you're going to do a small form factor build? I'm peacing out. Yeah. And actually, Nick, I gotta say, your two videos on the Fractal Terra, very helpful indeed. He had a review video. You should go watch it over on Gear Seekers. Review video and a Q&A video.
Oh.
Asking some good questions and answers. All right, so, oh boy. Oh boy, okay. All right. So that was a fun little pit stop.
I appreciate you taking time for science.
I just.
I appreciate it. Like, I wanted to try it, and then you did all the work for me. So you know what?
No.
I'm
fine with that.
Me.
I'm still kicking myself for not realizing I had the wrong GPU. All right. So in the meantime, what I'm gonna do to post it, I'm gonna use. We have a reference 6700 XT. So I'm gonna go back a generation. I mean, unless you want me to use
You know, I haven't had a chance to verify this yet, but some people in our Discord server were saying that the 6700 XT prices have started to climb again because so many YouTubers apparently are recommending it over current gen.
I mean, 6700 XT has been the go-to. I feel like the go-to card for like a while now, though. So,
imagine there were some people though who were still holding out on upgrades, right?
Yeah.
And they finally, after the current gen came out, they're finally like, you know what? Forget it. I'm just gonna
I'm
just gonna finally let go of my 970. I may or may not be referencing you, Boreas Zero. just get a 6700 XT.
Okay. All right, chat. I let you down. I will rectify this. I will rectify this later. Man, this card was so close though. I forgot that I had this Azrock version. Thought it was the Sapphire version. So, just pretend that this Sapphire version is what's going in here, because that's what's going to go in here. I'm just going to put it here.
That's fine. I just wanted the cookies out of the way.
All right. Oh, you know what? These are good. Willis, did you try?
I'm coming get some.
Asus once again reassuring us that we can just post via integrated graphics.
We could.
You're not wrong.
We could. We could.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I forgot to bring it to you. It's okay. I'm just sitting here like a jerk eating.
I'm trying to think, so.
Not thinking about other people who might be hungry.
I don't have that. The 6750 XT's at home as well. I have a 6650 XT. I have a 5600 XT. Should I post with that?
Wait, what?
The 6500 XT? Everyone hated.
It'll post. Check tips, potato. I feel like you were starting to write a fanfic with that comment, and I'm not sure if they're going to be into that. I'm just saying.
I'll put this over here. All right, so pretend this is a 7900 XT. Oh, look how dainty it is. This is just too small now.
What? I didn't know you were obsessed with size.
Too small. All right. Let's get this put back together. Hopefully in the right way.
Is there anything that goes around this part right here, or is that just open?
It's just open. It's an interesting design choice. I know some people say like, whatever. It's on the backside, so it doesn't matter.
I gotta worry about dust.
I mean,
I have cats, man.
Once again, there's no mesh anywhere, so this is definitely not a. The other thing I'm worried about is sound too. I do wonder the sound profile, because that is one thing I do like about the A4 H2O is fitting that 240 millimeter cooler in there. I got really good fan curves set up. I was very happy with the fan curve situation, and yeah, this is definitely going to be a different scenario. All right, so that's back. Let's screw this GPU back.
I feel like I'm going to regret this question, but Skeet Sayer, are you saying that you also are writing fan fiction about Adam and Gordon?
What is this? I missed this whole thing. I don't know if I want to know.
We actually did not go to 6500 XT. Adam was joking about that. We are temporarily going down to 6700 XT just to see if it'll, just to get it to post with a discrete graphics card in there that's Radeon.
Yeah.
It's a placeholder.
And now I can't remember, if somebody can remind me how many, what the power is like. I think on that Sapphire 7900 XT, it's 2 8 pin. But I can't remember off
the
top of my head.
It is so little though compared to that monstrosity we just tried.
I know, right?
It is so dainty. Also that R, I don't know what it is about it. Maybe it's also because of the red accents, but every time I see it, it makes me think of Pokemon.
Oh, yeah, yeah, Team Rocket.
Mm-hmm.
That's funny.
I'm not even a Pokemon person.
Gotta catch them all.
Jorge, yes, we do actually know about the movable spine in the case. Originally, we thought, Adam thought he was going to be building with the two-slot card, which is why I think he just left it in the default position.
Which, I mean, yeah, now that I have this 6700 XT in there as an example, I will be moving it over to the side because I want that 7900 XT.
But you're going to have to change the cooler fan too then, aren't you?
No, I have the bigger CPU cooler on already.
Wait, hold on. The 7900 XT, is that a two slot or?
It's a two slot. Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah. The Never Sapphire mind. Version is a two slot.
Never mind.
Which is why this is a stand-in just to show a two slot configuration.
Got it, okay. For a second I thought you were saying that the next card was gonna be three slot and I was like, wait a second.
No,
you're gonna
no,
have
no.
to change your fan.
Well, that's why I got both because if chat was gonna vote for the 4080, then I would have had to go three slot.
Right,
and then
with the shorter, yeah.
But now that I'm looking at it, I mean, that 4080 actually wasn't even all the way to the edge. So like this, in the default position, that three slot 4080 was like already where I would want it.
Hmm.
So I don't even know if I would have had to go with the shorter cooler, even with the 4080.
It depends, because the thing is that when people say it's a two slot card, it's a 2.5 slot card, it's a three slot card, there's still a little bit of wiggle room in there.
Yeah.
They're not all exactly the same, unfortunately. Yeah.
Well, that 4080 is definitely solidly three slot.
Everybody is running with the fanfic topic, and I don't know if
I should hate myself for
bringing this up. Gear Seeker says Adam and Gordon fanfiction is my dream. Liquid R says Gordon and SF small form factor in a coupe is my dream fanfic.
he's going to come back from his vacation and be like, what the hell is everyone talking about? You know what? Actually, bets right now, I don't think Gordon knows what a fanfic is. if I were to say, hey, Gordon, I wrote a fanfic about you, he'd be like,
what? Too late.
He'd probably play it off for a second and then be like, hold on, a fanfic, what the hell is that?
He's going to go home and ask his kids that night and then he's never going to talk to us again.
If I call it fanfiction, I think he would pick up on it at least, but if I call it fanfic,
oh my goodness.
I think he would be
no,
confused.
There's no way he can't know. I mean, like, that was, like, fanfiction, like, that was so big during, like, the BBS, that era. Like, he would know about it.
I am still missing a screw, and I'm a bit concerned, because I don't know where it is.
Not in a box?
No, it fell into this.
Oh, Shastis Eddie says that they got a 2.5 slot card to work with a 65 millimeter cooler in Noctua. That's a little
really?
Taller than yours. Yeah, it's a little taller than yours.
Because this one is
57, was it?
Yeah. Oh no, 55. Where did I put it? Oh, there it is. Yeah, 55. Oh wow. Yeah, I mean that's why I'm curious now because on their website they were like, oh, in this configuration, that configuration, but that 4080 was in the default position. So whatever this can fit right now, once we get it in there, that was where I'd have it. So, oh no.
Skeet Sayer saying that watching this makes me not want to do small form factor. It really, honestly, the experience really depends on the case that you get and how well you plan your measurements beforehand. Because I've had small form factor builds go incredibly smoothly. And then I've had other small form factors build go, let's just say it took a couple of tries.
But I mean, like, obviously what we're doing here, I'm experimenting and, you know, taking it apart for science. But I mean, if I would have had the card on hand that I wanted to have on hand and just thrown it in like I have this, you know, we would be well on our way or already done. So. Like this isn't exactly
is so cute. I'm sorry, like the case isn't even that big, but the 6700 XT in this case looks so adorable. I bet that card fits in like a 7.5 liter case really well.
It is a cute card.
It fit really well in my little metal fish case.
All right. All right.
Do you still have that Mac Pro inspired metal fish case I gave you?
Oh, yes, it's yeah, on our it's on our thing. Yeah.
Yeah, I think you should build that at some point. Cute.
All right. Well, I'm hopefully going to find that screw somewhere at some point. But in the meantime, we will continue. I think the next step, the next big question I have is the power supply. So I think I should get the like the L. So it says it has L support. Yeah, I have the one in my A4H2O.
Okay. And Skeet Sayer, yeah, the Cooler Master NR200 is really a great small form factor case to start with if you've never done small form factor before. It's closer to 20 liters, I think it's like 18 liters, so you get a little more wiggle room with it.
Yeah.
And it fits a lot more hardware. So if you're coming from a bigger case, it makes the transition a little less abrupt and dramatic.
And it's not sandwich style layout, so it's a lot more like easier for somebody to wrap your head around who's used to ATX.
My sandwich is really easy though, I feel like. The one thing I did, one tip though, if you've never built with the Cooler Master NR200, one thing that I found that's really useful was to buy fan grills. It makes the cable management, or lack thereof, if you have to do it quickly, as I did it that one time, makes it a lot simpler and you don't have to worry about your cables getting chewed up.
So I don't have the cables in. I guess I should try putting one of the cables in, but I mean, it looks like it fits.
Is it right here? Is it all exiting toward the bottom?
Yeah, yeah.
I would put at least one in though, because if the cable's really stiff at the connection point, it may be hard to like get that to fit comfortably.
Also, this does adjust, I think.
Does it?
Can move.
Can you raise it up?
Yeah. This can raise up one, so.
Oh, nice, okay.
I'm gonna do that. They have that extra clearance up here.
PHP says the screw, the one that you couldn't find, might have fallen into that GPU, by the way.
Oh. It went into the ASRock one?
Possibly.
Could have been. Yep, I don't hear anything wiggling, so.
Yeah, it might be.
Could be in the ASRock.
Is your screwdriver not magnetic?
No, it's not. It's weird.
Oh, that's why.
Gordon stole the Linus Tech Tip screwdriver.
Everyone's been saying that in the chat.
Yeah, I shouldn't say he stole it. He bought it with his own money, so it's his.
He took it home.
He's like, you know what? I'm actually actively going to use this at home.
Where is your iFixit case? That one's magnetized.
This iFixit?
Yeah, that one's magnetized. So if you need to use it to pick up screws, you can just use it for that.
True. All right, so I'm going to move this. Oh, huh. You can't put it up higher, can you? Oh, you can't. Oh, weird, I was wrong. You can put it lower. Oh,
you put it higher?
Yeah, you probably put it lower in the case of having a 140 radiator, I bet. So, okay, well.
Well, does it fit though with the cable?
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna try next. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna switch this. Wrong one. Oh no, that's the right one. Now I'm just thinking of possible Gordon small form factor coupe fanfic.
I don't think you should be encouraging it.
Somewhere VC Jester is furiously scribbling away.
Oh no, he's probably putting AI to the task, which is even scarier, honestly. Oh,
can I get that in manga form, please?
Oh no.
All right, so what's going to be the thickest? I guess probably the motherboard.
Yeah, the 24 power pin.
Yeah.
Sorry for it. 24 pin power connector. English real good sometimes. It's my only language. Even went to school for it.
Oh, there it is. All right, so.
Tech Hippie says, hope the screw didn't fall into the power supply, but you didn't even have it out.
I didn't have it out, no.
So we don't have to worry about that, thankfully.
So I'm.
Also, we have a really good overhead sprinkler system, so we should be okay. Gearseeker says that you can put it in a higher position.
Really?
Is there a manual?
There is a manual, yes. Do you want to?
Yeah, I can finally do some work for a change.
So
I'm just here eating.
Also, it does, the L does fit in there with the 24-pin power. It is definitely like...
This is a really nice manual, holy...
It is like, at the end of it though, like there's no way I would fit a fan in there and the cables. So, yeah, I guess it depends if we want a fan at the bottom or not.
Oh yeah.
Look at this manual. It's so nice. Look at this. All right, I think that's enough.
Nice highlighted, yeah.
All right, here we go.
So I did not see a way, so the way that it came installed, it has this little like lip in here. I don't know if you can see it. It has this little lip here. Mm. So I couldn't just put it higher. It was like you rotate it and it just makes it lower. So I'm not quite sure what Nick is saying. Maybe Nick's came.
Adam?
Yes.
The manual says that you should remove the side panels first and then the top one.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, weird.
Here we are. It's all the power supply.
I mean, I think regardless, I probably want to go with the normal. I don't need 1,000. The other one I have is 850.
I don't think it doesn't say anything about moving the position in here.
Rotating?
Let me look at the optional steps. You can do a different orientation of the power supply though. So like maybe if like your power cables are coming out funny, like that's how you get the clearance for them. So there's that.
Oh, wait.
So you can orient it differently, but you can't change the position of the bracket, I think.
Oh, wait.
Does that make sense? So you see here, so like this is like default, I guess, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right, and then you can mount it so that you can flip it, I guess. Oh, I guess it's not even changing it this way. It's just which way the fan is pointing.
Yeah.
Why would you want to point the fan that way?
So for blower or the flow through cards, there should be an accessory that allows it to have that gap between the GPU.
Okay.
So if the GPU is blowing through, because then you would want to intake here and then exhaust out top. But I don't have that.
Wow, thing. They even give cable management tips. Look at this.
Oh, nice.
That is a company that cares about its users.
Yeah, I like so how Nick, it's specifically
not like the cases I buy from AliExpress where they're like, here. Good luck.
Top lip of that mid plate. I don't know what you're talking about, Nick. It definitely, because there's only this diagonal configuration, so you either only do it this way or you flip it and do the diagonal the other way. And he says you don't need the fan in there, then okay, so I'm gonna try using it this way. If I feel like temps are bad, which I don't think they're gonna be that bad, then I can always try to put the other smaller power supply in and then.
Oh, Adam.
Yes.
You know, at the very beginning of the stream we were talking about the gullwing doors and how like they didn't seem like they'd move if you were transporting, because we're talking about, you know, taking this around like on an airplane or for like a LAN party or something.
Mm-hmm.
They actually have little things to secure.
Oh, wow, okay.
So that way you don't have to worry about that.
Dang, that is nice.
They have thought about that.
Jeez, yeah, Fractal, all right.
Yes. I love reading manuals.
They think of everything. Wait, so... God, maybe I should put in the normal size power supply. And just save myself the headache, because I don't need 1,000 watt.
It's now 340 somehow. I don't know how 40 minutes melted by.
Oh my goodness!
So it may be more expeditious to just go with the one you know will fit.
Yeah.
Wait. Oh, so the smaller one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Yeah, because I don't need this. I just wanted to use it because I had it on hand. And Wendell. Wendell had said it doesn't fit, so that's why I was like, wait, what?
But I'm gonna try that for science later.
Yeah. So let me. Oh, did somebody look up the power pin for the 7900 XT? Did anybody say that? I'm just curious if somebody in the chat knows the.
The Sapphire card you said?
Yeah, it's the Sapphire RX 7900 XT. I think it's 2.8, but I just want to know what I need to plug in ahead of time, just because then it'll be easier.
2.8.
Oh, okay. Nice. Perfect. Perfect. Oh, man, why? It is hard to unplug this motherboard. Power. Wow.
I once tweeted that I was like, the reason I work out is not to be strong, but to someday just be able to take out a 24 pin power connector without having to struggle. And then Brad writes me back. Now, for context, Brad does a lot of lifting. And Brad's like, keep dreaming.
Brad's like, yeah, no.
Oh, dang it.
All right, so unplug this.
Yeah.
So this is the 8-pin.
Thanks, Elena, for refill. I'll do it.
Oh, there's more drink over here too. Did you feel that? There we go. Did you feel the caffeine?
Kicking in, yeah.
I'm gonna take this power supply out. So the one I'm switching to is also a Silverstone. This is the one that they were sponsoring us for CES 2023. Silverstone, the leader in small form factor power supplies for over 10 years. This is the Extreme 850R Platinum. It is 850 watts. It is Cybernetics Platinum certified. So. There we go. It is free from the shackles of my old rig. I'll put that there later. I don't need this, so I'll put that there. So, CPU power, and then I need 2 8-pin from the box. I'm not gonna use this. 850R Platinum. All right, there's one 8-pin. Nope, that's...
Huh. At Computex, Gordon was asking everyone what is their benchmark food? Is that what it was, Adam?
No spoilers!
Oh, that hasn't come out yet.
No.
Teaser. We might
hold on to it.
Really?
We might get more from other trade shows.
Oh, okay.
Why, what's up, Willis?
Oh no, just I'm saying, what is everyone's PC build food?
There we go.
PC build snacks. Do you snack while you build PCs?
Yeah, I do, obviously. Yeah, I actually do wonder if a lot of people snack when they build, or if they're worried about grease
I'm so
or
sorry.
Fingers or what?
Somebody mentioned that they can't take the chewing anymore, and I realized I've been eating potato chips, and the mic's really close to my mouth. I'm really sorry, everybody. I forgot to mute.
Sorry. That's also me, too.
Thank you for bearing with me so far. I will remember to mute from now on.
Okay, so that is... Wait, what is this? Okay.
Liquid R points out that you can have lots of strength in your body and still have low grip and finger strength. He says, I wonder how climbers would do with the 24-pin connector. That's a good point. Rock climbers have insanely strong hands.
All right, so all the cables are in. I need to... Where is that? Oh, okay. Huh. You know what's weird? Oh, you know what? I I wonder, you know what? It looks like they actually expect you to take the bracket out because there's no way you're going to screw these in with this in the way. So, interesting.
All right, we got some people saying almonds and cheese. What else? Just beer.
Just beer.
Just beer for, you know, snacks, building a PC.
No, I'm good, thank you.
It's like, yeah, if you don't want your fingers dirty, maybe use chopsticks to snack.
So like, if I go like this.
So speaking of, I don't know if you mentioned that during this stream or Half Nerd, but somebody I know will use chopsticks to eat Doritos and Cheetos.
Yes.
While they're gaming, specifically.
While gaming, yeah, right.
Because they don't want to get their controller dirty. And I heard that and I was like, oh, wow, that's really smart.
I've gotten ads from Instagram before where it's like those like finger chopsticks. It's just like you're slotting in between, you know, your
I don't know, I couldn't do that. It's like, for me, it's like full chopsticks or bust.
I've seen that as well, yeah, the ones that just go on the top of your fingers. Yeah.
Weird.
Because you don't want to spend time to pick up the chopstick, eat it. You just want to quickly, you know, grab it, eat it, and then like quickly grab the controller.
But then you still run the risk of the powder touching the controller. No. Full chopsticks or bust.
Full chopsticks or bust.
For me. For me. You know, you do you. But I'm going to do me, and that is full chopsticks. Because the other thing too is that I don't like having to like quickly shove something in my mouth between things. Like, if I'm gonna eat, I'm gonna wait till a cutscene and I'm just gonna like eat my stuff. And then I'll put it down.
But what if you're online, you're playing multiplayer? There's no cutscenes. There's just some load times, but they're like, well,
I mean, when I'm waiting to queue for a match, there's plenty of time to eat. Especially because I've been playing Overwatch mostly with my friends as of late. And so there's always at least a solid 40 seconds at the start of the match, even when you like exit queue and are like matched, you know?
Right.
So that's 40 seconds of solid eating. There's a lot of rice and stir fry I can put away in that time. I finally did. I've put this off for years. I mean, I've done it periodically and then I conveniently forget. I looked up again how many calories there are in a cup of rice. I was like, why did I do this? Now I know I eat like 1,000 calories worth of rice with each meal. Maybe that's the reason why I've gained weight. But I like rice so much. It's hard to give up.
It's hard, yeah, rice and noodles.
I had
carbs, all carbs.
I had a friend early on, like right at like around turning 30, went to the doctor, and the doctor's like, you know, you gotta cut down your white rice consumption because it's gonna make you like pre-diabetic. And my friend just looks at him. It's like, the doctor, who is not Chinese, not Asian, looks at him back and is like, is like brown rice a problem? And my friend just keeps looking at him.
like, you don't know.
Like, what have you asked me to do?
He's like,
the dude's like, well, I guess it must be different, but you gotta do it anyway, buddy. And my friend's just like,
he's like, are you joking right now?
But you're kidding me, right? Look who I am.
Gear Seekers, I appreciate the idea, but I don't think I could blend my stir fry and consume it that way.
Into a smoothie. Oh my goodness.
I mean, the idea is good. Like, it is a very, very expedited way to get those calories in, but I don't, texture wise, I don't think I could do it.
Oh, Nick. That's pretty funny.
Can you imagine, like, if my mom were to pack me lunch for school, and she's like, you know what, I'm too lazy to just pack everything for you. I'm just gonna blend it in for you, son.
No.
You know,
here's rice last night's hot, you know,
sweet and sour
pork.
No,
all grinded in together.
Nope, with some veggies on top.
Oh boy.
You know, I'm not against it. I'd try it. Nope. I'll try anything.
That texture would, like, for the flavors, I just don't think that texture would work for me. No.
So luckily the power button, so I only need one front panel header, and the power button is on the board rather than this riser card thing.
Ooh.
So that's nice. I'm close.
Yeah, that does seem like
so the power,
one of those nice perks you get with an expensive motherboard.
Yeah.
Liquid R says, didn't Gordon say he was going to blend a sandwich? Sounds like something he'd say.
Yeah,
I don't know if he actually said it.
Oh, he did.
Oh, he did? Oh,
yeah.
When did he say this? What was the context?
We were talking about Subway, or what were we talking about? We were talking about sandwiches.
Oh, no.
Why would he?
And we were talking about going and getting lunch, and I was like, all right, I'll make sure he blends his sandwich. So, yes, that is something Gordon said.
My goodness.
On air.
No.
To the world.
No, thank you. Let's see. Tech Tips Potato wants to know, how do you spice your rice? I am very Chinese, and I will definitely just eat plain jasmine white rice sometimes. No, not even necessary to have anything with it. Except I get really hungry without other things, so that's why I eat vegetables and meat with it. Otherwise, it's just like pure carbs, and my body's like, nope, you need more than that.
Yeah, I grew up with just loving, you know, plain white jasmine rice with Chinese dishes, because Chinese dishes are already so full, flavorful, and it's just like you.
It's a good balance.
Yeah, it's a good balance.
It balances it out.
Yeah. But if I do need to spice my rice, garlic fried rice, or something else.
Do you need to spice your rice?
You need to spice your rice sometimes. Garlic rice something else. I forgot.
I just love rice, which is why I'm like, wait, 1,000 calories? I have to reduce my consumption. No.
So, growing up, my mom made minute rice.
Oh no.
What?
Box minute rice all the time. That was the rice she made, but she didn't make it the way you're talking about.
Oh dear.
She would make it the way you're supposed to make it minute rice, and then literally put like almost a whole thing of butter. So it was essentially butter rice.
I mean, that's a way to flavor it for sure.
That's how I grew up. Rice to me was a butter, rice pudding, almost.
I had a friend once tell me that they couldn't stand the taste of butter. Like, they hated butter. And we all looked at them like, what happened? And they looked at us like dead in the eye. They were like, I had a babysitter. When they were tired of taking care of us, they would take a whole stick of butter, roll it in sugar, and give it to us for a snack.
Ooh.
They're like, I can't stand butter anymore. And I was like, you know what? After you explain that context, it makes a lot of sense. We will never push butter or margarine on you again.
Oh, man.
What would you like with your bread, if anything?
Oh, now I'm curious. Oh, my God. Wow.
It's really interesting to me, though. Like, honestly, like, the comments in chat, there are so many people who can't understand the idea of not putting something with your rice. I think that's a really big divide I've noticed culturally between people who grew up eating, like, Far East Asian food, at least, and people who grew up in, like, more Western-style cultures with rice. Like, rice to them is something that you always have to season or flavor. For me and a lot of my friends growing up, like, sometimes it's just nice to have a plain white rice snack, or like making a rice congee, like a plain white rice congee. Yeah. Like, it's really,
yes.
It's like a good palate cleanser, like resets, like it's just very like neutral.
Yeah.
And honestly, it's a little sweet to me, honestly, so.
Yeah, so how there, you know, Western culture, probably Western culture, correct me if I'm wrong, chicken noodle soup would be a thing you eat when you're sick, right? I would eat it sometimes too when I'm sick, chicken noodle soup, but I would also make congee, Chinese porridge, as a palate cleanser.
I often got that when I was sick too. Like when I got my wisdom teeth out and I couldn't really eat anything, my mom just made this vat. I mean, like literally, it was just like gigantic stock pot full of white rice congee made with chicken stock and like really, I guess this is where we blended, very finely shredded chicken or like almost blended chicken. So that I could just basically swallow. I didn't need to actually chew while my gums were healing.
Did she use a blender? Just like
blended. I don't know. Anything noisy was a misery for me at that point. So I think I blocked a lot of that memory out.
So I think I'm done.
Yay!
Now that I'm looking at it, I actually don't think. I mean, it's funny. We've gotten this far, and I haven't moved the spine. But I actually don't think I could move it over one notch. I'm curious.
Why would you want to move it over a notch right now, though?
Just to get it as close as I could to intake on the side. Mm. So I'm curious what it would. Oh, I think I need to do the bottom as well.
Also, because someone decided to comment on it, yes, I do still wear a mask in 2023. And that is my personal choice. I don't force it on other people. Mm-hmm. If you have a problem with it, I'm sorry. That's your problem, not mine. I'm not asking you to wear it.
So it's not sliding. I guess I have to loosen up a little bit more.
Oh, soy sauce and rice. That's the other one I forgot to add. So
I wasn't going to say it. It is very triggering for me.
Oh, well, check this out. So what I do is actually not soy sauce, but ponzu. I use ponzu and then I add an egg and then I stir. It's a very Japanese way that I learned.
Egg, that's different.
Ponzu, Japanese. Ponzu, egg, and then some green onions as well. And then stir.
That's really good. Yeah. That's really, really good. I just have philosophical issues with people who literally just pour soy sauce onto white rice and eat it like that.
That's my mom right there. I was like,
really?
That's not healthy for your mom. It old school. She's very old school.
I have a huge extended family. I have never met anybody who's done that. Wow.
Only when my mom's she's tired of cooking because, you know, she has two kids and just like, you know, I'm tired of you kids, just forget about it, I'm just gonna cook, have some soy sauce over rice and then some veggies, you know, veggies always a good must need a balance diet. Yeah, so she's like,
what I really like to do, like, if I'm feeling lazy is excuse me, I can't think of the English word for it, sunny side up egg.
Oh yeah.
And then a little bit of oyster sauce.
There you go. Ooh.
With rice.
Yes.
So good.
So I actually can put it over one more notch.
Yeah.
If I needed to, but I mean, since I'm going a two slot card, I'm gonna go all the way to the other side. I'm just curious because, so you loosen, oh, interesting. So these orange tabs are not supposed to be permanent. It just comes with it, okay. And then you find the spot you want and then just screw it in with the included screws. So like literally this whole spine is like floating right now.
Ah, so it's not like set positions.
No, yeah, it's floating and you don't even have to go by the numbers.
That's,
I think,
really
they just
cool.
include
like,
the numbers.
I actually like that a lot because that means that you can get just the wiggle room you want without having to fully commit to like a whole discrete different position.
Yeah. And even though like I've unscrewed everything and it's literally in here, it's still caught between these two lips on this side. So it's not like it's like falling out, you know, if that makes sense. So like it's just sliding back and forth. And everything is literally on here. So, which is kind of cool. So yeah, okay, so if I go two slot, which is literally takes me all the way to number one. So if I go with a two slot card, look how much, yeah, I could easily put a bigger cooler on here.
Yeah, so.
Wow.
I forgot how to pronounce the name already.
Hmm.
But the person who was in chat earlier talking about their Terra build, saying that it's like there's like wiggle room, right? Because as you saw,
yeah.
So even though it's not officially on the spec, you can still like squeeze another, I think they said 5 to maybe almost 10 millimeters.
Interesting.
Out of it.
Dang, this is pretty cool. Yeah. Okay, so now that I know that, so yeah, because I was going officially by spec, and so I mean, so was Ziv. So this isn't on Ziv either. Who helped me? Oh my god.
Oh, Adam.
Nope. I see it. It's right here.
There you go.
Even though Ziv was the one, he was just going off spec as well. So
I mean, that's all you can do because
yeah.
every case is a little different in terms of how much wiggle room you have.
Yeah.
And it depends also on how you build and what you build with.
Yeah. So I'm in number two slot, so I actually could come over a little bit more. I'm going to keep it there for right now because I'm pretty sure that Sapphire card is just a straight two slot, just like this. But it might be just a bit thicker.
I mean, we can look at the picture right here if you want. Oh gosh, what happened?
Okay, so it does have just a little bit of a lip.
It has a little bit, but not nearly as significant as the other card. Also, to answer, whose comment was it? Gabriel de la Cruz. It is not a 7900 XTX. We could not fit that. And it wasn't meant to be an XTX originally. It was only meant to be an XT.
Yes.
But Adam accidentally brought the wrong card, it sounds like.
Well, I had it here and I was like, oh yeah, that's the card I'm going to use. And then the other one is at home. Yeah, so, I mean, you can get an XTX in the two slot. It's just we had an ASRock
XTX. It's a big boy.
That is I mean, the thickness isn't even the problem, it's the length. And I mean, it's
a long boy then, but still a big boy regardless. Yeah. Decently sized card.
So, yeah.
Although, do you remember that 6800 XT that I had for I think it was the Leon Lee?
Yes.
Case teardown where I'm like, I can't fit this in here. I don't think I can do it. What's happening?
All right, well, I got everything in. I mean, the cable management isn't fantastic, but you know, whatever it is what it is. Let's post it. Let's post it, shall we? All right, so why don't you do a poll right now, Willis? Mm-hmm. Will it post? Will my streak continue? I am the undisputed posting champ, except for one time it didn't post, but that wasn't my fault. I thought I flashed it.
I mean, that is technically still your fault.
I thought I flashed it. It would have posted it if the flash would have worked.
Adam, I think it's time for you to admit that it's okay not to have a perfect record. It is actually more realistic if you've built as much as you've built to not have a perfect record. It's really easy to have a perfect record when you've only built once.
You know what, Elena?
Or twice.
I don't appreciate this. Okay, also, that's fine. We're just not gonna count that one.
Also, speaking of rice, and since we're having this like fantastic rice discussion right now in the comment section, I will say for non-Asian rice dishes that I absolutely adore, paella stuff is freaking sent from the gods. I swear, so good.
Ugh. All right, can you see the camera or the screen okay,
yes.
Willis?
Yes, all right.
I have voted in the poll. I have given you my full vote of confidence.
Good.
You are going to post on
first
try.
I'm gonna vote too. Get your votes in, folks. Get your votes in. I need a power cable.
Boreaziru is predicting that you're gonna get a short because of that missing screw. Borea, why?
No, what did people say where the screw was?
In the 40, well,
probably in the 4080?
The ASRock or the 4080?
Either in your gigantic ASRock card or the 4080.
Oh, the ASRock, yeah. I bet it's in the ASRock card. Because I think I lost it around the ASRock time of this blur that has been a PC build.
Tech Hippie is asking now if the BIOS is updated for the X3D CPU. I'm assuming yes, because that case was already used when I pulled it out of the box. So I have a feeling Adam may have done some tinkering before the build.
No, the motherboard was brand new. The motherboard was sealed, so.
Oh, is that why you're giving me that look?
Yeah, I'm giving you that look because
it's a genuine one.
It would have posted if I would have updated the BIOS, is what I'm gonna say right now.
Number two.
No, we'll see. Wait, no, but it'll still post, right?
No.
No?
No, if the BIOS is not updated for that CPU, you are not gonna get a post, typically.
Oh no, all right.
And I've done that before. I pulled out a motherboard thinking that it was updated, put in the next generation CPU, and been like, why is it not put?
Oh no.
I gotta tear it all down.
Jesus Christ. All right, well, let's see. I mean, I did get this. When did I get this motherboard? I guess it was a couple months ago.
Where is
crap? It? Oh man.
I mean, it probably will post. I mean, it's not like a brand new generation a CPU. I don't know. Mm. I'm trying to help you along here. Yeah. I'm trying to give you, send you good vibes. Oh,
thank you. I appreciate it. All right. So the switch is on.
Okay. Cross your fingers.
Cross your fingers that I. All right. We got power. Oh. It's powering up.
Fans are spinning.
Fans are spinning.
Where are the lights? Where are the indicator lights? Can you see them?
I don't think this board has indicator lights.
What? It's so expensive. How can it not have some kind of readout?
Is the monitor on?
The monitor should be on. Yeah.
It is on. It actually has the white light, so it could be memory testing right now or memory.
No, the first post always takes
a little longer. Yeah.
A little longer, so I'm not worried yet. Not worried yet, but yeah, motherboard lights. I don't know if this one has.
Yeah.
Postcodes.
Well, I mean, not even postcode. Sometimes what happens is you get those little indicator lights, and so the color will tell you what, it, like at least give you a clue whether it's the memory or some the CPU or something else. Monitor's blinking.
Asus coming in saying that you did not connect the Hive, but it also integrates the QLED diagnostics LEDs for visibility.
Yeah, they're diagnostic LEDs on
the. Is that what this is? LEDs on here? Oh, the Hive. Oh, no. The Hive is the external card. Oh, I just heard it power cycle, so that was probably memory training. The Hive is that little thing.
Oh, is that true? Dave's not here, man. They only get actual code readouts on $700 boards. That hurts. Like, I remember them being available on like 175, 200 boards back in the day. Although I guess with inflation, it's probably higher now. Oh.
I just heard a power cycle.
Oh. Yeah, I heard a power. Oh.
There it is.
Oh, we got lights on the keyboard. Yay!
Hey! All right, I don't have a perfect score. I get it. I don't have a perfect score, but at least this one posted.
Yeah. Wait, so have a chip installed. For celebratory snacking.
TPM. Yeah, whatever.
It always says that.
Yeah. yes, celebratory lobster tail snacking. Hmm. I'm still really curious about these Oreos. Why does it have that? It is very interesting taste. White chocolate. That is not white chocolate.
It really tastes like there's like cream cheese kind of vibe to it.
I'm gonna have to have two.
Just for science.
Oh man, wow.
We did it, everybody.
I was a little worried there. Well, now it's not coming back up again, but that's fine. It posted. We saw it once. Wow, okay. Whew, that was a build. I'll tell you what, that was a build.
Why does it keep cycling though?
Probably the memory training.
You shouldn't have to keep training that memory though.
It's
also a really loud fan. Is that the CPU cooler?
No, that's on the motherboard. Yeah, that's the motherboard. There's two little fans in the motherboard, one right here and one right here.
Oh gosh, that is so loud.
Yeah.
Maybe not.
Oh, now it's fine now. Okay, yeah. So this says BIOS version, is this it?
Yeah, 0423.
Yeah, 0423. So I'm not quite sure how update that is, but it does see it as a 7800X3D.
Yeah.
It sees both drives.
Yeah, I mean, there was a moment where I also like you was like, oh, but then I was like, wait a second, it's like still same generation. Like, usually same generation, you should be fine.
So. Yeah.
And somebody in chat actually did say like they had the same experience where they didn't actually bother to update the BIOS and it was still fine.
Oh, it was still fine. Okay. Yeah. Well, you got me worried. Anyway, before we wrap it up, I will say I love this case. I mean, I love the A4. Okay, listen.
You can love more than one.
It's true.
Case.
It's true. I'm just trying to think. So my first small form factor was that Q58. I love that Q58. I had a damn good time with that Q58. I treated it really well. And then the A4H2O. I like the Q58. The looks of it. better than the A4H2O, but the A4H2O was just real easy to build in.
It's a joy to build in that thing.
And just dead simple for small form
and
factor.
And the cooling's a bit better.
Yeah. This is fun. Like, not only is it like just elegant, beautiful looking, like I do love the look of it. Like, having that ability to say, to go back and forth and be like, hey, you know what, I have a two slot card. Oh no, I have like a three slot card. Like,
yeah,
it is well done. I'm trying to think of anything that I would be like, I didn't quite like on it. I'll say the one thing that is kind of weird that I don't quite like on it is the fact that the power cable is like pre-routed into the front. Like I kind of understand why they kind of have it out of the way, but like it is a little unwieldy if you're trying to move stuff around. Like I would have been fine with it just kind of floating. And then if that's the case, they probably wouldn't have had to put the rigid parts in there, so you could probably get a little longer of a GPU, but that's a side note. I'm trying to think, like...
People are in the chat are asking, do you want to look at temps right now?
Oh, like going to the BIOS, or...
Yeah,
so...
Just press F1.
F1 to run setup. Yeah, let's go in. Well, I don't know...
Your sides are off, though, so that's going to be a little different.
Yeah, I can throw it back on.
And Asus says that's a launch build version of the BIOS.
Oh, okay. Wait, so you said this goes back on first?
I guess so, because that came off second after the, I think you have to shift it forward.
Oh,
yeah,
you're right.
There you go.
VC Jester just got back from work. He's like, just in time to say goodbye.
Oh, VC Jester, you...
You missed quite the
you
stream.
Missed
yeah, you missed a lot of...
You missed the fan fiction discussion. Maybe it's best for us that you did.
Yeah. all right, so, well, what's... Whoops. Wait, so how should I test temps? Without a Windows install.
I think people just want to see what your temps are.
Oh.
So just put just preliminary, just put the fans on, let it sit for a few minutes, see if it changes.
So it says the motherboard temperature, 30°C. I don't know exactly what it's reading there. Maybe JJ can say what this specific motherboard temperature is. CPU temperature is reading at 34°C.
That's pretty good.
The CPU fan is at 650 RPM.
We should say, though, that this room is very well air-conditioned, though. So
yeah.
Our ambient temperature is pretty low.
Ambient temperature is really nice. It's 67°C in here, so.
Not C.
Oh, not C.
Not Fahrenheit. C, we'd be dead.
Oh, it's 67°C in here. Send help.
You would be dead.
Okay.
So yeah, if anyone knows, like, yeah. I know there's like a memory test that is usually in this BIOS.
Yeah, so it's gone up by a couple degrees with the panels on already. So if you let it sit maybe for another couple minutes, we can get a better sense of that.
So, there you go. I thought there was
Also, you do, Asus is recommending that you update the build for your BIOS, saying that this is not a supported build, just has base microcode support. Any build from 1413 on up is fine. The current recommended build is the current one, which is 1616.
Oh yeah, yeah, no, I'm definitely gonna update it. I just didn't think to do that beforehand. okay, so here we go. I'm in the temperature monitor place. Oh look, there's a F. There's a Fahrenheit readout as well.
Oh,
I've always
Americans.
Wondered. Yeah, thank you.
Thanks, Asus.
So it's at the top one, CPU temperature 35°C, CPU package temperature 46°C, motherboard temperature 32°C, VRAM temperature 30°C, chipset 1 temperature 61°C, chipset 2 temperature 51°C, DIMM A temperature and DIMM B temperature 32 and 31°C. So, and then nothing on this. This is a T sensor temperature. I'm not quite sure what that is, and that's no readout. So.
I mean, the panels have been on for a couple minutes now. We've seen it go from, if I remember right, we were looking at 29°C for the motherboard, and I think 33 or 34°C for the CPU, so we've gone up only by a couple degrees. But again, we are in a pretty cool room right now. The AC is actively blowing right
now. Yeah, yeah. No, this is best case scenario, and obviously, I mean, we're not under any sort of stress test. It is funny now that I'm seeing it from the backside that you can just like see right into.
Yeah, it kind of bothers me personally. I like having my cases more closed off.
I don't think there's a way. I mean, how would you combat that though?
What do you mean?
Like, if Fractal was like, oh, you know what, we still want the spine to be able to move, but then once it's in place, not have these gaps.
Some companies will, like, at least for this long lengthwise one, I don't know if y'all can see this. Maybe we should turn it toward the camera?
I can tip it up like that if you want to go overhead. Well,
yep.
So in some companies, what I've seen them do is that they have, like, a bracket. Right, mm-hmm. Like a couple different bracket sizes that you can put in there. So, for example, not small form factor, but the O11D Mini has something like this because you know it's modular and you can reconfigure the configuration. I'm getting hungry or tired, even though I've been snacking apparently. Anyway, there's different configurations you can do, and so depending on which one, they have different brackets you can put in there so that the back is completely, you know, kind of walled off, so you don't have just like direct flow of dust and pet fur going in there. So like there'll be a spine kind of, not spine, a panel bracket thing that you can put here sometimes, and there's like another smaller one that also kind of mounts right onto here so it secures it and holds it in place. So I would assume that they could have done something like that if they wanted. I'm actually wondering if some people are going to put out maybe like
a mod or something?
Like yeah, like maybe someone will like produce an accessory for that specifically, or I don't know. 3D printing is not going to work as well because it's plastic and won't look as nice with the metal.
But the other thing too, if somebody's going to do that, they're going to have to make that size at every number because you don't know where it's going to be, right? So it's like whatever slot, so they were like, hey, you know, like if you have it over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like
it's going to vary. Yeah. But it would be nice. Maybe there'll be an Etsy store that will open. So maybe this is a thing for somebody out there who does, you know, stuff on Etsy. Like you can make it your thing where you create a customized bracket thing.
And then I just want to show the bottom. Like it has the perforate or the slots are even bigger than what's on the side panel in the top panel. So you can definitely mount a fan here. It's weird, there's actual mounting holes here, but you definitely can't fit a fan there, so I don't know what you would mount there. And here's where you screw in the wings so they don't open up.
Yeah.
Cool, I mean, all in all,
it's a nice little case.
This is a damn good case.
Do you know if they're gonna have different wood colors available? Because, I mean, I dig this like more mahogany kind of color, but I think a light, more like blonde color panel would be cool too.
So I don't know if Ziv's in the channel or not, but I know he had tweeted Fractal, and I was gonna actually email them because he had asked to like ask a question. But you can actually take this wood piece off,
yeah.
And they do have like a design, like a CAD design or something, if you want to replace it with something else. So I mean, that's obviously, you know, somebody has to specifically do that. But I have not heard any information that they're gonna sell different pieces of wood. And honestly, I thought the wood would be different based off of the color you got as well, but it's all the same. I have seen it lighter though. Like, I mean, just because they're unique pieces of wood, I've definitely seen like lighter
and
darker versions.
It's like luck of the draw, right? Yeah. So you can't necessarily predict it. I personally would like a lighter colored one.
Oh, Ziv said he stained his. Wow.
He did.
Dang. Nice.
He actually put in, like, he also spray painted his, I think was a blue. He did like a light blue, if I remember right, Ziv.
Also, sorry, somebody said, how is the PPE for doers? How is the fan sound? I mean, I'm not hearing anything right now.
Relatively quiet, yeah.
Yeah, I actually don't think the GPU fans are spinning. Oh, they are. I mean, but it's really low RPM. The actual CPU fan says right now it's at 735, 37 RPM.
Earlier we were hearing sounds from the motherboard, was that?
Yeah, so there's two little fans on the inside the motherboard, uh-huh. And they, like, when it was training the memory, it cranked up, but I don't think it's gonna be
Hopefully those don't go off again, yeah. But I would say those, that sound profile is more of a high-pitched
sound. Oh, for sure, yeah, sound. Yeah. So that's like, laptop
that,
kind of
yeah,
sound.
Yeah, if you don't like that sound, then just keep that in mind.
Yeah. So anyway, any final questions in here before we get to it? Oh.
We have a super chat.
Wow, we got a super chat. Big $20 super chat from Gunga Din. Thank you so much. I appreciate that.
Thank you.
Rice on me.
That's a lot of rice, actually.
And beer for
going to Costco.
I appreciate that. That's awesome. We get a whole bag of rice and then a couple beers. Let me get my drink, my assorted drink here. Oh, that mango tea is actually pretty good. So
it's pretty good, yeah. Cheers.
Yeah, cheers. Cheers to a successful build. Thank you, Willis, for controlling the verticals and the horizontals.
Hey,
Elena, thank you for coming and hanging out.
Ooh.
And checking this out. Any final thoughts from you?
I'm glad to see more options. I love Fractal's designs in general. Also really excited, look how beefy this thing is. I keep saying this, but front panel is just like solid. Just happy to see more options out there. The thing I would like to see next is more options in the micro ATX small form factor space. It's very small population of cases out there, especially ones that are affordable. A lot of them, I was talking with a couple people on Discord about this, and they were like, yeah, I built with this and it fits, in a micro ATX case, a motherboard. I was like, how much? Like 200. And I was like, I don't think I want to spend that much on my case right now.
Yeah. This is what, 180? I think it's pretty close to 200. So it's definitely.
That's funny. That's why this is so
high-end
solid.
Item.
Look at this chunky.
Yeah. I understand the Gordon's like, oh, it's, small form factor is just more expensive and yada yada. I mean, again, can be for sure. But also I feel like he's not into aesthetics as much as somebody like I am. So like for me, I'm willing to pay an extra premium. I did not pay for this case. I will say Fractal sent me this case. This is a review unit. I'm not saying I paid for this, but I would pay for this. I do like this case.
It just seems like a really nice, solid, long-term thing that you would want to keep around.
Yeah. Right. And I mean, the ability, the configuration options are pretty damn good. I do like that. I mean, yeah. I do wonder if maybe they're gonna have a revision that makes it a little taller so that you can put a 240. Oh, you know what? Now that I think about it, maybe it's just too hard to have a cooler, but then also have a movable spine thing. Maybe it just complicated it too much. Not quite sure. Anyway, yes, this is, wow.
I
feel tired. I feel tired. We chowed down on snacks. We had a damn good time.
Yeah, it went for a good 3 hours.
PCs.
Yeah.
I love building PCs, and I love that you hung out with us this whole time and voted. And don't worry, I will post pics over on Discord once I get the 7900 XT in there and all set up.
No false advertising.
Yeah,
just
no false
advertising.
I'm not going to put the 4080 in there. That 4080, I mean, unless I have a problem with the 7900 XT, but I don't think I should. So. Anyway, I'm gonna get out of here. Thank you, JJ, also for being in the chat and helping answer my stupid questions. I guess coming up, we'll do a full Nerd next Tuesday.
Mm-hmm.
So join for that. I don't think Gordon's gonna be back for it, but maybe there's a chance he might.
We'll see.
I do have a guest lined up.
Oh.
Should I spoil it for the people who are left or?
I mean, they did hang out with us this whole
time. They did hang out. Jared Walton, friend
oh.
Jared Walton over at Tom's Hardware
is
going to join us. So we're going to talk about serious stuff next year for sure, or next week. At some point, Gordon will come back and we'll have fun. And also, at the end of this month, Gordon Willis and I will be at LTX. So
you're going to LTX?
Hey.
We're going to LTX. We're going to be streaming both Saturday and Sunday from the ASUS booth. Thank you to ASUS for sponsoring that kind of show, and it's going to be fun. I'm excited for that. If anybody is going to LTX, let me know because I would love to meet up, see you at the booth and say hi.
You should organize an actual meetup then.
Maybe we should.
That'd
Maybe
be
we
fun.
Should.
No, try something.
Maybe we should. Yeah. In the meantime, thank you again, everybody, for hanging out. And yeah, check out our stuff later. We have stuff coming. I don't know. I'm
stay
tired.
Tuned.
Stay tuned.
Watch, keep an eye on the channel.
Yeah. Thank you, Willis. Thank you, Elena. Thank you, everybody. Have a good weekend. We will see you later. Bye.
Bye.